We are back in Glendale, John Forslund and Joe Micheletti, and that is Shea Weber, the captain of the Nashville Predators, nominated again for the Norris Trophy as the NHL's best defenseman. Ray Whitney, 77 points in the regular season. In just a few days, he turns the age of 40. And as Ryan Suter looks up, he understands that defense gets it done. They only allowed 9 goals against in the 5 games against Detroit in round number 1. We are set to go at Jobbing.com Arena. The season series was even, but 3 of those games were played a long time ago. Nashville made a few adjustments down the stretch. At the trading deadline, some players who have stepped in. One of those at the top rim of the circle, Alex Radulov, riding a 4-game point streak. As Martin Hanzel, David Leguan, cross stick, sit back and enjoy this series. Western Conference semifinal, 3-4, 3 being Phoenix with home ice. Off the draw now, Radim Verbata broke it up. Martin Hanzel for Phoenix to an open corner. Oliver Ekman-Larsson keeps it deep. Verbata in back of Pekkarinen. Hanzel wheels it back to the point. Ekman-Larsson off a stick, off Verbata. It's in play, and it's wheeled out by the Predators and Shea Weber.
John, that was a set play right off the faceoff. Phoenix just fired it down, didn't worry about the icing. They sent Ray Whitney down into the offensive zone. That led to some early chances.
Boyd Gordon can break in the faceoff circle in round 1. Kevin Klein moves it out for Nashville, and you see it come all the way back. Snapped off the boards and snapped ahead by Adrian Acoin. And now Klein defends on Lori Korpakoski, and the play is whistled dead offside. Let's take a look at the numbers for tonight's starting goaltenders presented by Honda Pilot. For Mike Smith, an outstanding round 1. As you take a look at those numbers, he looked at 241 shots in the first round, stopped 229. Pekkarinen, second straight season, a nomination for the Vezina Trophy. It starts and ends with a 6'5" goaltender who's been so great over the years and for many reasons underrated, but now among the elite.
Well, last year, 4th in the voting for most valuable player in the league. That tells you a little something about how the league feels about him.
He's been nominated for that award with the Rangers' Henrik Lundqvist, who was outstanding in their first round playoff win, and Jonathan Quick. Same can be said from Los Angeles. Shane Doan. Now Patrick Hornquist has it for the Preds. Tries to move it by Antoine Vermette and does. Nashville out to center ice. Hal Gill, first game of the playoffs. Nick Spaulding. Patrick Hornquist denied by Mike Smith. As the Coyotes try to clear, Keith Yandel takes over deep in his own zone. Yandel out to center. A nice shift on Spaulding. His shot negated at the defense. Blocked by Weber. And the Coyotes turn it back out to center ice. Adrian Acoin was a healthy scratch in game 6 against Chicago. Back in tonight for Dave Tippett. Now the puck comes all the way back to the Nashville zone. Ryan Suter denied it. Center, Gilbert Brule turned out by Rene. Now Damon Lanko. Rusty Kessler with a shot denied off the blocker of Pekkarinen. Kyle Chipchura with a big performance in that 4-0 win in game 6 against Chicago. Try to get it deep. Acoin, D to D.
John, that's the 4th line for Phoenix that it was so effective in that series against Chicago. What a chance.
And Joe, that's their key. They have to have balance in terms of their forwards.
And it's interesting in talking to Barry Trotz, the head coach for Nashville, he just feels that this Phoenix team is deeper up front than what they saw against the Detroit Red Wings.
Roman Josi defends for Nashville. It goes out of play. We'll see the chance for Gilbert Brule.
Brule had a game, had a goal in game number 6. Here's the good work. This is a team that will forecheck. They'll come in and put the pressure on. Excellent chance by Brule. And there you see the agility of Pekkarinen at 6'5". His ability to go from post to post. He got over there. By the time he got there, not much to shoot at. Excellent save.
Yeah, his athleticism is truly amazing when you look at his size, and sure, he plays angles and blocks and does all of that that goaltenders today build on, but his athleticism is second to none. Now Mike Fisher. Sergei Kostitsyn through the middle. Predators over the line. Martin Erat for Fisher. His shot swallowed by Smith, who gets the stoppage. Let's go inside the glass, presented by Capital One with Joe Micheletti.
John, you know, in this series, we've got two of the great coaches going against each other in the National Hockey League. For the Phoenix Coyotes, Dave Tippett has done a marvelous job here, and he told us before the game, the key to winning the series for his team, be consistent and have a lot of resolve. And as far as Barry Trotz, what a job he's done as the only coach in the franchise history. He talked about execution and being very patient against a team like Phoenix that can really frustrate you.
Boyd Gordon out in front, denied. Good back check by Alexander Radulov, and now Nashville will clear. Back out to center ice. Gabrielle Bork, the rookie. Radulov comes calling. His shot goes wide. And Boyd Gordon in control for Phoenix. Back out to center. Korpakoski is injured in the first round. Missed a couple of games, but Phoenix is healing. They feel better than they have in a while. They have not played since Monday. It's been a long layoff for Nashville. They ousted Detroit a week ago. Taylor Pyatt held up in neutral ice. Wanted a call, none provided, and Nashville will restart with just about 4 minutes gone in the first. Andre Kostitsyn, another one of those add-ons, coming over from Montreal at the deadline. Kostitsyn holding onto a diagonally across Ryan Suter. His shot through traffic is blocked. Mikhail Butker is on it, and out he comes. He had two overtime game winners in that first round against Chicago.
And that was the young Ekman Larson that blocked the shot. You'll see him plenty, almost 27 minutes a game, just 20 years of age. We talk about the great defenseman, the pairing for Nashville. Keep an eye on Ekman Larson. He is really coming of age.
Yeah, Joe, he was with Phoenix a season ago, did not play in their first round exit against Detroit. It stepped in a big way against Chicago. Craig Smith with a shot wide of Mike Smith. To the top of your screen it goes. Smith engages Brulé. Out of the four-man scrum, Kevin Klein hammers one high over the top of Smith. Roman Josi moves it ahead for Nashville. Broken up by Derek Morris and back out to center.
It's actually a good pace to start this period. Nashville was the team to watch because, as you mentioned, John, all that time off, but they're skating, they're moving, they're making good plays.
Barry Trotz said this morning he felt that his team took a game to get into the second round against Vancouver last year. Does not expect that this time around. Shane Doan defended by Hal Gill. Doan stays with it. Vermette with four goals broken up.
Erat, good defensive play.
Marty Erat back the other way, crisscrossing. But the play is whistled dead offside at the Phoenix line.
Now these two teams, they're both very good defensive teams, and when they get the chance, they'll take you out physically. That Francis Bouillon, he's not very big. Good solid hit on Boyd Gordon.
We saw that from the LensCrafter RoboCam. Francis Bouillon at plus six is a franchise record for the postseason for Nashville.
He's a very competitive player. Again, he doesn't have great size, but he's got a tremendous competitive spirit.
But he's so solid, Joe, huh? 5'8", 198. Laser then, I guess you could say low center of gravity, out to center ice. Gabriel Bork, denied by Martin Hansel. From the wall, David Legwan, moving it by Alex Radulov, who now will come all the way back towards his own zone. Radulov is handcuffed by the pass from Legwan, and now the tandem of Weber and Suter take over. Out to center, Radulov lays it off for Gabriel Bork. Laid at the line by Adrian Acoin, and now he'll get it from Radim Verbata. Just about 6 minutes gone in the first period of game one. Shots are even, two apiece. Ryan Suter clears it all the way back. Now Michael Roosevelt. Paired on defense with Oliver Ekman Larson. The 20-year-old out to the center zone. Korpakoski gets it deep. Kevin Klein was outstanding in that third game of the Detroit series with a goal and one of the best saves of the playoffs. Korpakoski denied by Rene, but a penalty will be called as Lauri Korpakoski had the chance. Phoenix gets a golden opportunity. They go to the power play when we come back.
First great chance of the game thus far. Kevin Klein loses the puck. Here's the turnover. Going the other way was Korpakoski, and he gets tripped down right there. Doesn't get a shot off. The Coyotes were arguing that there was a stick thrown on the play. Kelly Sutherland, the referee, just came over and explained why he did not call it that way.
We take a look now at a Bacardi power play for the Phoenix Coyotes. Better in the postseason than they were in the regular season. Regular season number 29. The postseason right now number 5. 7 out of 19. Martin Hansel deals it along, and now they play it this way for Ray Whitney. Whitney holding onto it. Diagonally across. Good read by Nick Spaulding, who clears it out.
Stick was just in the perfect position. Spaulding had his body one way. Stick was on the ice in the passing lane, intercepted it, and easily cleared.
Now Yandel out to center ice. It's Phoenix power play, 4 out of 19 in round one. Here's Verbata holding up. Back to the point. Yandel holding onto it. Ekman-Larsson. Keith Yandel. Oliver Ekman-Larsson moves it along now. Whitney assesses. In deep, Verbata. His shot scores! Radim Verbata! And Phoenix strikes first.
This is outstanding movement by the Phoenix Coyotes. Watch how all the dark colored sweaters keep moving to get in the open area. Verbata ends up with it. 35 goal scorer during the regular season. And how about this shot? Absolutely perfect. Didn't look like much was there, but Verbata in the wrist shot finds a way to get that in. The all-important first goal of the game goes to Phoenix. That didn't look like a 29-ranked power play in the regular season, did it, John?
No, it didn't. Verbata only lasted 30 seconds in game one of the previous series. Left with an injury. Returned in that series against Chicago. But on the mend and feeling better, obviously, by that shot. Ray Whitney, Oliver Ekman-Larsson get the assist. The goal comes at 7:23. Verbata with his first of this playoff round and his fifth career playoff goal. Alexander Radulov approaching that Phoenix defense. He'll move it wide. David Legwand off the board, guarded by Pyatt. Kevin Kline's shot picked off by Smith. No further play.
And a good job in front. And I think these players are starting to get into this second round here. It started off fairly passive this game. And now with Phoenix scoring the first goal. Now the other key is that Martin Hansel is back as well, number 11. In fact, that line is reunited. They didn't play much together in the first round after so much time, and he just gets in front of Rene, trying to screen him. Didn't screen him on the shot, but he forced Rene to continue to try and look around him. But Hansel, Verbata, Ray Whitney, what a line they were during the regular season. And again, didn't play much together because of injuries in round number one. They're back together now and off to a great start.
Well, and Hansel, Joe, is an outstanding defensive center, too. In size, very important down the middle as the puck is cleared out by Keith Yandel. This will be icing. Francis Bouillon back on the touch. Will swing it back in the Phoenix zone.
Now, Barry Trotz. What a job he's done throughout, and he keeps talking about when he started 14 years ago when they just wanted to try to be competitive. And they've gone from being competitive to now expecting to win. And they built, along with David Poile, the outstanding general manager, quite the team. A lot of people think Nashville's got what it takes to win the Stanley Cup this year.
Hornquist now to an open corner. Yandel gets there for Phoenix. Kyle Chipchura pressured by Hornquist. Andre Kostitsyn to the point. Kevin Kline goes wide. Holds onto it. Centers one off a couple of sticks. Yandel gets it back. He'll move it along the wall where it's captured by Kyle Chipchura. Back out to center. Phoenix on the transition. Damon Lanko. Gilbert Brulé, his shot nullified by Bouillon. Brulé takes the hit from Bouillon. Gilbert Brulé tries to leave it there along the wall. It pops out. And it's hunted down by Francis Bouillon. Phoenix now keeps it in the Nashville zone. Lanko turns it back to the point. Ekman-Larsson, he'll go deep. Pekarinen out to play it, fanning on a clear. Shane Doan in control for Phoenix. They'll grind a bit of a cycle here. Doan with a shot, rejected by Rene. To the corner it goes. Bouillon with a hit on Doan, and that allows Kevin Kline a chance to get it from his own zone and back out to center. Saturday Major League Soccer continues on the NBC Sports Network. Thierry Henry leads the red-hot Red Bulls offense against the New England Revolution. All rise for Major League Soccer Saturday at 3:30 on the NBC Sports Network. As that puck deflected out of play, the faceoff outside the Nashville line. Shots are 4-3 Phoenix. The power play goal from Radim Verbata. Now Plesla plays it for Adrian Acoin. A bouncing puck, Sergei Kostitsyn, Mike Fisher. Great pass for Marty Erat, denied. Plesla going down out in front.
That puck bounced and Erat could not get a stick on the puck. It deflected off his skate.
Now reversed by Shea Weber. Ryan Suter.
And John, the first time in this game that the Whitney line is not out against Weber and Suter.
Acoin through the middle. Lays it on the wing. It goes by Shane Doan. Pecorine leaves it for Shea Weber. Get away from that Phoenix forechecking, and now it's carried out by Alexander Radulov. Radulov over the line on the wing. Now it's centered by Erat, denied by Smith. Roman Josi with a shot. Tipped high by Radulov. Now Leguan goes to work on Ekman Larson. Martin Hansel tries to clear for the Coyotes. Whitney attempts to get it out, and they do with help from Verbata. Klein turns it back for Gabriel Bork, and now it's played over the line and carried in by Radulov. Alexander Radulov out in front. After the point, Kevin Klein holding. Slap pass for Radulov in back of Smith, defended by Ekman Larson. Now Leguan to leave it there for Radulov, and it's frozen by Mike Smith. So we get a stoppage. The celebration, the first one in this series, belongs to Radim Verbata. Phoenix 1, Nashville no score. Back in Glendale, time now for the Kia Motors coaches interview with Dave Tippett.
Dave, what do you think of the start of the series?
Well, both teams, it's a little feeling out process. We got a break there, got a power play, and scored a big power play goal to give us some momentum, but you can tell it's early in the series. Both teams are playing pretty close to the vest.
What do you think the key is to winning?
Well, you have to stay consistent in your effort. Both teams are going to work hard. Both teams got to continue right through, but the team that gets the breaks and has that consistency in their game is usually going to come out of the game on top.
Appreciate your time. Thanks.
Thank you.
These teams mirror one another, there's no doubt. Common threads on both sides. The coaches this morning talking about the same things and looking for an edge, Joe. Each team trying to get to that playoff edge in a series where there's not a lot of animosity in terms of what goes on in the regular season.
No, but it will grow. It will certainly grow. And Barry Trotz said he thinks it's only going to take one game because he said there's not much history between these two teams, but he said one playoff game will do that.
And the one goal scored by Radim Verbata, the power play goal. Set up by Ray Whitney, along with Oliver Ekman Larson. Whitney has assisted on 21 of Verbata's 36 goals this season as plays comes to a halt.
Well, and so many times, too, you talk about breaks and turnovers and making the right play. Phoenix here with the turnover in their own zone that leads to this chance. But you see, after the turnover by Adrian Acoin, he came back and got his stick on this right here, deflects it so the puck bounced and rolled, and Erat not able to get a stick on the puck, ended up deflecting off his skates, and meanwhile shorthanded. So first power play chance for Nashville as Radim Verbata goes off for high sticking.
And this power play is brought to you by Husqvarna. Nashville goes to work. Round one, 2 out of 22 against Detroit. Ryan Suter brings it along for Alexander Radulov, broken up by Boyd Gordon. He'll get it out. Weber and Suter on the points as always for Nashville.
Yeah, pardon me. And one of the reasons they only scored two power play goals in that series against Detroit is Detroit tried to put a lot of pressure on both Weber and Suter.
Barry Trotz getting Mike Fisher, Marty Erat, and Alex Radulov up front. Erat lays it off for Fisher. Back to the point nicely for Shea Weber. Weber this way for Ryan Suter. Through the slot and off the wall now. Fisher in control, guarded by Korpakovsky up front and Morris down below. Radulov from the half boards. Alexander Radulov. To the point, Suter. One-timer Weber wide of Smith. Now it's played by Radulov again. Across for Weber, give back for Suter. His shot fumbled a bit by Smith, loose out in front. Weber goes after it to the corner. Radulov dangles back to the point. Ryan Suter watched by Boyd Gordon. Moving up, Radulov again. Marty Erat will stretch it out.
Penalty killer's tired now.
Erat trading places with Radulov. Suter with a wrister, blocked in front. And a good block it was by Kleslah as it comes out. On the line change, Shea Weber goes deep. Patrick Hornquist for David Legwan. And the pass unattainable as it went by Ryan Suter all the way down to Pekarinen.
Now Korpikoski's also able to change with that clear. He was out there a long, long time trying to concentrate on keeping the puck away from Weber and Suter, but they had it quite a bit and had a few chances.
9 seconds left on the penalty to Radim Verbata. Shane Doan. Pressured a bit by Andre Kostitsa, and the Coyotes get to it and clear it back. Nashville had one shot with that power play. Roman Josi, David Legwan defended by Oliver Ekman-Larsson, who has that great stick.
And the other thing that we'll see in this series is that Phoenix does a marvelous job of blocking shots. They had two or three on that first penalty kill.
They have killed off 15 in a row now in the postseason. Mikhail Butker through the middle. Butker throws on the brakes, lays it off for Verbata. His pass defended by Josi. Butker moves it astray. Getting to it is Verbata. Broken up. Played here deep and cleared out by the Predators as they get it back out to center ice. Francis Bouillon on Karam. They get to it and score. Brandon Yip with a fortuitous bounce, and Nashville has tied it.
Well, as Smith went behind the net, that hit either the boards or the glass and came back to the front of the net. Yip was there, and also Yandel. I'm not so sure Yandel didn't get a piece of this. Here it comes to the front. There's Yandel. Now, Yandel just couldn't quite reach it, and Yip just happened to be in perfect position. Innocent-looking shoot-in, but it goes off the stanchion of the glass. Smith, who was one of the best puck-handling goaltenders in the game, if not the best, was out to play it and had no chance as Yip was able to just deflect it into the empty net, and that goal ties things up. Remember, Dave Tippett was just talking about breaks? There's a break right there for Nashville.
So Brandon Yip, who they acquired from Colorado off the waiver wire, has put himself in a great spot in the playoffs. Damon Lanco walks in. A good play by Kevin Klein coming back. Lanco again denied by Rene. And we get a stoppage. 5:37 left to go in period one. Brandon Yip in the right place at the right time. We're tied in game one. Well, it takes all kinds of goals in the playoffs for Brandon Yip. It came at the right time. And Joe, for his team, it came at the right time.
Well, it did. I thought after the power play goal by Phoenix, they had a little bit of momentum. And you hear coaches talk so often about changing that momentum. That did.
Yandel, Whitney with a shot off a stick off Ryan Suter. Martin Hansel gets to it. The Predators now clear it back out. Keith Yandel broken up. Carried in the zone now by Patrick Hornquist. The Preds are offside as they cross. Let's take a look at tonight's Coors Light cold hard facts. As we take a look here at droughts and turns of playoff series, and the Phoenix Coyotes went a long while. 1987, they were the Winnipeg Jets, but they ousted Chicago in six, so they break the hex, but they've never won a game in the second round, which is interesting as we take a look at Coors Light cold hard facts.
Yeah, it really is, John. And you, again, getting back to Shane Doan, the captain, who has played 16 seasons before this being his first time in the second round of the playoffs. He said, and he had chances to leave, and Don Maloney, the GM, gave him an opportunity in years past to go to a different team that was in the playoffs. And he said, no, I want to stay here. I want to stay in Phoenix. We've got some unfinished business.
Phoenix has qualified for the playoffs the last three seasons. They won their first ever division title in the final weekend, winning the Pacific, winning home ice in this matchup. As play is whistled dead and Martin Hansel protests.
Now Hansel was going in on the forecheck with Shea Weber. And let's see who touches it first. Oh, it was Hansel. But the linesman was on the other side. And I think the two bodies and both big players probably blocked the linesman from actually being able to see that Hanzel is able to get his stick on the puck first. Nonetheless, faceoff comes back into the Coyote zone.
Hanzel wins it cleanly away from David Legwan. Puck now deflects on a play. We get another stoppage. 5:02 left in period one.
Shots are 7-5 favoring Nashville. That's when it's been an interesting period from the standpoint of just watching to see how these two teams are going to play against each other. Lori Korpikoski, before the game started, told me, I asked him, I said, what do you see when you look at Nashville? He said, I see us. He said, same thing. He said, we play the same way, four line, very good defensively.
That's why we expect a long series. Now comes back to the corner. Legwan gets to it. Rattle off for Nashville, defended by the Coyotes' Michael Roosevelt. Punched out by Taylor Pyatt. He gets a step on Klein. He walks in. His shot sealed off by Rene, who gets the faceoff.
Taylor Pyatt, who had one of those seasons that was frustrating for him, but came on towards the end of the season. He makes a good play here on Kevin Klein, and then will reach. Klein tries to reach. He thinks he's got him with his speed, but the long reach of Taylor Pyatt pushes it ahead and allows him to get that shot. And Pekka Rinne, all 6'5" of him, makes the save, and he's able to control the rebound.
Antoine Vermette wins it back. Questla with a shot off the stick of Shane Doan, loose in back of the goal. Marty Erat for Nashville, pressured by Rusty Questla. Now the Predators attempt to get it out, brought in offside by Shane Doan, who doesn't like the call. Tomorrow's schedule for more Stanley Cup play. Washington and the Rangers, game number one on NBC at 3 Eastern. At 7:30 Eastern, Los Angeles at St. Louis, game number one from the West. As we present every game of the Stanley Cup playoffs. Now it comes free, a shot taken. Rinne makes the save and covers the attempt by Shane Doan. And another faceoff in the Nashville zone.
And actually, it's going to be a penalty. Suter is going to get the call. He took down Shane Doan. And Suter doesn't like the call, but that'll give Phoenix their second power play. Doan will do a spinorama. Suter is 20. He gets a stick between the legs. He tried to let go of his stick so that Doan wouldn't trip. And even though he let go of the stick, that didn't prevent the penalty call.
Phoenix with their second power play. Brought to you by Craftsman. Nadim Verbata with a power play goal at 7:23. They have he, along with Ray Whitney, Martin Hanzel up front, Keith Yandel, and Oliver Ekman-Larsson on the points. Faceoff won by Paul Gostad, snapped by Kevin Klein. Nick Spaulding is tied up by Keith Yandel out of that scrum. They wedge it there, pops out. Klein in a battle with Hanzel. They keep it deep. Hal Gill rifles along the boards by Ekman-Larsson out to center. Now Nick Spaulding is away with Paul Gostad, but it's broken up, and the Coyotes will swing it back. Verbata steps in. Shot taken, blocked by Gill. That's what he does so well. Back to the point. Ekman-Larsson played in offside by Keith Yandel.
Now, John, as you mentioned, Hal Gill playing in his first game of the playoffs this year. And one of the big reasons they acquired him at the trade deadline is penalty killing. Big man at 6'7", and he's in perfect position there to block the shot. Earlier, he was able to fight for a loose puck behind the net and clear that as well. All kinds of experience. Stanley Cup winner, important part of this penalty kill for Nashville.
Faceoff controlled by the Predators, Shea Weber. Moving it by Sergei Kostitsyn. Kostitsyn along with Mike Fisher up front for Barry Trotz. Roman Josi and Shea Weber on the back end. Quarterbacking out is Keith Yandel. Moved off for Antoine Vermette. He has three of his four goals in the postseason on the power play. It was by Mike Smith. Yandel in control, and Phoenix has just under a minute left in this power play. Yandel walks it out to center. Heels off for Ekman-Larsson, who steps in. Oliver Ekman-Larsson throws on the break. Lays it off for Mikhail Bakker, broken up. David Legwan will clear it out. And Yandel, good skater, gets there ahead of Marty Erat. Hal Gill chops it all the way back in the Phoenix zone. And
much better penalty killing this time around for Nashville. Phoenix just not able to set anything up, get anything going.
Phoenix down to 25 seconds on the power play. It's broken up. And it's dumped out again by Nick Spaulding.
And you go back to the power play goal that Phoenix scored. They were able to carry the puck in the zone and then set things up and move the puck around. This time, Nashville just not allowing them to come in the zone, and this should be an icing. Well, they just wave it off. But again, the penalty killing outstanding.
Shots even, seven apiece. No shots for Phoenix on the power play. Hansel's shot blocked on the way through. Francis Bouillon will elevate the puck by Mike Smith. And this will be icing with Derek Morris back on the touch.
Well, we talked about some of the top defensemen in this game, and we also mentioned this young man right here. How about this move on Hal Gill? Oliver Ekman-Larsson with that smooth little move. He's only 20 years of age. And when you talk to coaches and teammates, Michael Roosevelt, his partner, he said, this is a kid you have to keep an eye on because he has made such huge strides. He's still growing. He's still just, as I mentioned, a 20-year-old. So physically, he's still growing, but very smooth, very cool, very calm on the ice for a young player.
Sixth overall pick in 09. Sergei Kostitsyn goes after it, defended by Adrian Apoin. He'll move it back. Phoenix now will start from their own zone. Wojciechowski is sealed off along the wall by Fisher, and again it comes back in the Coyotes zone. Vesla moves it off. Played here by Wojciechowski. Hampered a bit by Hal Gill. It hops all the way back. Nashville in control. Ratloff swings across with 1:34 left in period one. Fisher checked by Oliver Ekman-Larsson. Roman Josi, good-looking young defenseman, maintains control. Nashville gets a change, and so does Phoenix as you see it come all the way back in. Ekman-Larsson will wait patiently. Chopped ahead by Gabriel Bork. Inside it goes Mikhail Butker. Checked by David Legwan and now Kevin Klein. Headmans the puck for Legwan. A wrist from well out, no problem for Mike Smith, and he'll move it. But he turns it over to Bork. Wrap chance denied by Smith, and now he'll slow it down.
Now, this is something that even the Chicago Blackhawks, Smith is so good at handling the puck, they decided to start throwing pucks at him. In fact, in one game, they had over 20 shots on goal that were from outside the blue line in order that if they throw it at him, they don't think he'll have as much time to stop the puck and make a play, that it's more difficult as he has a difficult time there. So the oncoming forwards can go straight to the net, go straight to him and try and take some of his time away.
57 seconds left in period one. John Forslund with Joe Micheletti, who's inside the glass. Jobbing.com Arena, game one of this best of seven Western Conference semifinal. Nick Spaulding plays it along the boards and out. Andre Kostitsyn for Nashville goes deep. Mike Smith, one of the best at that, playing the puck, deals away for Derek Morris. Hampered though in the forecheck, the Predators keep it deep. Out of the corner, turning with it now, back to the point, Hornquist. Ryan Suter, Andre Kostitsyn, here's Hornquist denied. Combination of Whitney, who has the puck, and Keith Yandle. Ray Whitney goes wide, throws it across for Yandle. 20 seconds left in the period. Stolen by Shea Weber, will get it all the way down to Mike Smith.
And Yandle was wide open, the puck bounced over a stick.
Whitney steps in. Radim Verbata from a tough angle denied by Rene. Whitney has the rebound. 5 seconds left in the period. Sergei Kostitsyn for his brother Andre. And out they come. Sergei Kostitsyn shot off a stick and it sails out of play. 9-8 favor of Nashville in terms of shots. 1-1 after 20. Coming up on the first intermission report with Liam McHugh, Mike Milbury, and Keith Jones. Exploiting Smith's strengths and the Capitals' Discover defense. That all comes your way after the break. One period down in round number two out west. Radim Verbata on the power play scoring for the Phoenix Coyotes. And on a lucky bounce, Brandon Yip has tied it for the Nashville Predators. The Stanley Cup playoffs presented by GEICO. You're watching the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by GEICO, round number two, game one, Glendale, Arizona. The exterior of Jobbing.com Arena and the Glendale Sports District. Brandon Yip scoring on an odd bounce off a glass support, being in the right place for the Nashville Predators, tying the game after Radim Verbata scored on the power play for Phoenix early in period one. That's where we stand as we get set for the second period. John Forslund upstairs. Joe Micheletti is inside the glass. pretty decent pace to the first period, Joe.
Yeah, I thought so, John. And the score indicates how evenly played the first period was. The shots indicate the same at 9-8.
The only thing that was not even dominance in the faceoff circle, Phoenix won 78% of the faceoffs in period one.
And what's interesting is that generally when you win that many faceoffs, you should be able to generate more shots or have a bigger shot advantage.
Mike Fisher over the line, goes wide, lays it off for Marty Erath. Off the paddle of Mike Smith, defended by Phoenix at the defense by Rusty Kletzla. Now Mikkel Butker lays it along for Shane Doan, the Coyote captain. Now comes across for Shea Weber. His shot off a stick. It goes off Antoine Vermette, and it goes out of play. Let's go inside the glass, presented by Mercedes with Joe.
Well, Barry Trotz, the head coach for Nashville, was talking about how patient you have to be when you play against Phoenix. And here's one of the big reasons you have to be patient. Look at the block shots. They'll see this throughout this series. They'll go down, they'll block as many as they can. They'll help out their goaltender, Mike Smith. They'll have their sticks in the passing lane. They'll have bodies in the middle of the ice to prevent you from getting there. And young Ekman Larson is one of the best at using his stick and making defensive plays.
Their D has size. They collapse like so many teams do, but Phoenix does a pretty good job in front of Mike Smith, and he handles the rest. Ball start off the faceoff. They'll do it again. Gabriel Bork for Nashville, Martin Hansel for Phoenix.
Another win on the faceoff, but Nashville ends up with the puck.
Alexander Radulov all the way across for Roman Josi. His shot is tipped high. That's played along the boards by Radulov for Gabriel Bork. David Legwon checked by Michael Roosevelt. Out of that corner battle, it's punched out by Martin Hansel. And out come the Coyotes. Legwon defending on Hansel. Nashville takes over. Gabriel Bork had an outstanding first round against Detroit with 3 goals. David Legwon goes to work down deep for Bork. His shot blocked by Roosevelt and played by Oliver Ekman Larson. Phoenix down through the middle. Martin Hansel with Whitney. His shot negated by Roman Josi. Played here by Nick Spaulding. And out they come. They'll move it by Keith Yandel to go after it himself. He gets control. He'll lay it off. Broken up by Yandel. Now it's cleared ahead by Laurie Korpakoski back out to center. Hal Gill, Patrick Hornquist. Shot taken, easily detected by Mike Smith. And we get a stoppage.
Now you see Hornquist take that shot. I had a chance to talk to Mike Babcock, the head coach of Detroit, a couple of days ago, and asked him about his opinion, of course, after they lost in 5 games to Nashville. And he said the one thing about them, he says, he reminds me of back, you know, when we had a lot of depth on our team. He said the real good thing and the dangerous thing about Nashville is that they have a lot of depth up front. And here's Hornquist, who's playing on the third line, and this was a player that a couple of years ago was on their top line. It gives you an idea how much offense they have up front.
And they have quality depth they can go to in the stands, too, in terms of healthy players, as Mike Smith handles that one from Patrick Hornquist, who had 27 goals in the regular season. Taylor Pyatt now will wheel it all the way back.
And, John, you mentioned that extra depth now. It was actually an adjustment, too, for Barry Trotz to have to figure out a way to use 24 players instead of 20.
But depending on the game, the opponent, and the conditions, he has options.
Yeah, and the other thing was this, and Detroit has done this for years as well. They've used those young players, and they haven't used them as much in the playoffs. They let them play in the minors, they let them watch, and they become better players.
At the line now, Korpakoski goes deep. It's whistled dead offside. 17:29 left in the second period.
And there's an important player for Phoenix in Laurie Korpakoski. He is emerging into one of those players, especially under the system that Dave Tippett uses. Korpakoski's got great speed. He is an outstanding penalty killer, led their team with 3 shorthanded goals, and now his game has developed to the point where he's used on the power play as well. The question is, can he stay healthy?
That's right. He only played the 4 because of an injury, returned in game 5, but he had 17 goals during the season. A loose puck, a wrap chance through the goal crease. As Nashville buzzes on the forecheck, and now Kyle Chipchura with a cross-corner dump in. Roman Josi back to play it. Chipchura gets to it, back to the point. Adrian Acoin shot wide of Pecorine. Craig Smith, who had an assist on the goal scored by Brandon Yet. Kletzla out in front, and rolls in! Off a body! Rusty Kletzla makes it 2-1, Phoenix.
you talk about fortuitous bounce. 59 in white is Josi. He'll make a block of the shot right here. Watch where the puck goes. Right back to the other side. And there's the easy tap-in. Block of the shot. Goaltender Pekka Rinne was going the other way. And there's Rusty Klesla to put it in. Before the game, Dave Tippett, the head coach, told us when we asked him about playoff performers, he said, Rusty Klesla, last year he was their best defenseman in the playoffs. This year, he's been their best defenseman again in the playoffs.
He had 3 points in the third game of the Chicago series.
And really has never been known to be a scorer. He's been more of a defensive-minded player throughout his career.
On the first-round draft choice of Columbus, they acquired him last season from the Blue Jackets. Martin Erat stops, lays it back. Stand on one-timer by Shea Weber. Loose out in front. Erat goes to work, defended, broken up by Michael Rosenbaum. Weber with a pinch for Nashville. It's knocked down. Played ahead by Boyd Gordon. Gained by Taylor Pyatt, who takes a hit, but gets it back out to neutral ice. Phoenix with a 2-1 lead in game one. Martin Erat centers one. Good back check by Taylor Pyatt on Sergei Kostitsyn. Francis Bouillon with a wrister blocked in front. Pyatt in control again for Phoenix. Gained by Nashville's Erat. Marty Erat lays it off for Francis Bouillon, who goes deep. Bouillon along the boards. Moves it off here for David Legwand. Turning is Erat. Turning away from Ekman Larson. Back to the point, Hal Gill. Slap pass off the wall. Good stick by Mike Smith. Played again by Legwand. Encumbered a bit by it was Bouillon. Now they get to it. Nashville in control. Good shift. Legwand for Gill. Hal Gill through bodies and wide. Rattle off. Plays it this way again for Gill. Here it comes. It's tipped wide of Smith. Played by Bouillon. Turns back to the point. Hal Gill one more time. David Legwand in the high slot. Turning away from the pack is Rattleau. The wrister trickles wide of Smith. Going down Gabriel Bork. Dug out again by Alexander Rattleau and played out finally by Korpakoski to relieve pressure, and Phoenix survived.
Best offensive shift of the game. And there's an icing. Some good offensive opportunities. Here's the pass across. Little redirection there. Not everything on the shot, but Smith is overweighting and is able to make the save. And then Nashville went through a long period of time, a good 45 seconds or so, where they kept the pressure on, and this is a smart timeout. Dave Tippett's going to use his timeout. Remember, Phoenix took the icing. That's after his team was pinned in their own zone for a good 45 seconds to a minute at least, because Nashville during that time was actually able to get some fresh players on the ice. They were making changes, getting fresh players on the ice while Phoenix was stuck in their own zone. And eventually Phoenix takes the icing. Dave Tippett makes a smart play here by using his timeout.
While we have time, let's take a look at tonight's storylines brought to you by Gillette Fusion ProGlide. Story tonight, the three goals that have been scored early on the power play. Radim Verbata with his first. Then an odd bounce, but Nashville takes it. The goal scored by Brandon Yip. In this period, another bounce off Roman Josi, right to Rusty Klesla, and that's where we stand. Just about 5 minutes gone in the second period.
John, everyone thought that this was going to be a low scoring series because of the great goaltenders on this side. Well, you know, the coaches are kind of thinking, hey, listen, this is the playoffs.
That's right, Joe.
When you think something looks so obvious and that's going to happen that way, you know, both coaches have told their players, expect anything and everything.
Yeah, the first round, that taught us well. You never know. Yandle now moved off a stick. Forecheck by Nick Spaulding. Phoenix now clears ahead. Wristed off the boards by Patrick Hornquist. Yandel goes D to D. Derek Morris. Good pass out of the zone. Shane Doan will bounce it past Pekka Rinne. Good look in the corner at Shea Weber. He plays it along the boards. A pinch by Yandel. Nashville gets it out. Through the center zone, Ryan Suter goes after it. Now Martin Hansel at his side. It's rolled ahead by Doan in on Rinne, and now played again by Shea Weber. Nick Spaulding turning back. checked on the play. Good job going into the forecheck by Phoenix's Martin Hansel.
Penalty coming up on Phoenix, John.
Under the late whistle, it's cleared out to Patrick Hornquist. His shot deflected wide by Mike Smith. Six skaters out. Phoenix finally gets possession, and we get a stoppage. We'll get a power play when we come back. We just had a goal from Rusty Klesla. 2-1, Phoenix.
Nashville power play. Here's why. Nick Spaulding, watch his head. Is a little bit down on the play. Hansel comes in with the elbow, though, makes contact, elbow to the head. His argument was that Spaulding lowered his head. Didn't matter. Power play Nashville.
And it is power play number two as that pass deflects back out to center ice. 13:35 left in the second period, game one. Western Conference semifinal, best of seven. Phoenix with a 2-1 lead, the go-ahead goal from Rusty Klesla in the second period.
And the player to watch is the man with the puck right here. Shea Weber's got the big shot. He led Nashville in shots on goal in the first series with 18.
Back of the goal played here by Rusty Klesla. Phoenix has done a remarkable job shorthanded so far in the playoffs. Now Weber. Across it goes Ryan Suter. He'll move it down the wall. Suter holding onto it up top. Fisher in control, shot stopped by Smith.
Now even on that play, John, you could look, when Fisher looked up, he delayed even though he had time to shoot, because when he looked up, Smith could see it. There was no one in front of him, and Fisher was trying to delay this enough so that somebody could get to the front of the net. And there it is. That's an easy save for Mike Smith. He just gobbles this one up. Fisher kind of took his time waiting for someone to get there, but he had to pull the trigger, and Smith made an easy save.
Antoine Vermette doesn't like it. They have two centers out. Damon Lenko now will replace him. Leguan for Nashville in the circle. Batted around. Roosevelt has it off the boards. Good keep by Sergei Kostitsyn. Defended by Lenko. Held in again by Sergei. Off for Andre Kostitsyn. Sergei Kostitsyn. Roman Josi with a bouncing pass. He'll keep it deep. Hornquist turns it off a body. Gained by Leguan. David Leguan for Patrick Hornquist. Defended beautifully by Michael Roosevelt. Loose impact of the goal. Hornquist now up top. At the point, Sergei Kostitsyn. Moved off his brother Andre, and it's cleared out again by Phoenix. Killing more time.
Two or three times, Kostitsyn made very good play, keeping the play alive. Phoenix was unable to clear it, and finally are able to get a change.
The aforementioned Sergei Kostitsyn gets it deep. Mike Smith will play it. Roman Josi reads the play, goes deep again. Derek Morris, the veteran defenseman, off a stick, not out. Andre Kostitsyn, Roman Josi. Josi delays, moves it inside. They turn it up top. David Leguan for Roman Josi. He gets a lane, his shot locked in front. They go after it. Boyd Gordon has it for the Coyotes, and he kills time.
And that save by Smith, he didn't see it. He was in perfect position, a lot of bodies in front of him, and then got help from his teammates to clear.
One shot on the power play. Taken by Nashville out of the corner. Spaulding had it, he lost it, and it's cleared on the deflection out of play. Wednesday, May 2nd, the NBC Sports Network begins unprecedented coverage of the 138th Run for the Roses, featuring classic derby races, draw for post position, and insider access. It all leads up to the Kentucky Derby, Sunday, May the 5th, on NBC.
Now a change, a late change by Dave Tippett. Remember, he's the home coach who has the last change, and he elects to put his number one line on the ice against a very good checking line. Spaulding's done a very good defensive job this season, and he's out there against Hansel. And you mentioned it, John. Hansel, one of the best two-way centermen in the game.
Brandon Yip plays it deep. Nick Spaulding now tries to center one. Brandon Yip in control. Nashville goes to work, defended by Adrian Acoin, and Verbata chips it along the boards and gets it all the way back. Shea Weber, Predator captain in control. Nick Spaulding, defended, good force by Klesla. Here they come. It goes off Weber, turning with it now. Ray Whitney, all the way across by two, by Verbata, by Acoin, and again back. Mike Smith, Adrian Acoin. Klesla through the middle. Here's Hansel. Moved by Whitney. Verbata goes after it. Ryan Suter got to it. A steal by Whitney. Left in the corner. Verbata gets room. His shot scooped up by Pecorine.
Well, Verbata, Whitney, Hansel, back together. And what makes this line so dangerous is you've got scoring on the wings with Whitney, the great passer and a 1,000-point man now in his National Hockey League career. You've got Verbata, who's the great finisher, and then you've got Hansel that does both. So they're able to play this line against any line in the National Hockey League. You can play it for defensive purposes, which Dave Tippett has done. And also, if you've got a power play, they're the number one unit out on the power play as well.
Shots are 14-11 Nashville off the draw. Yandel's bid is blocked by Fisher, gained by Shane Doan. Off a stick, off Hal Gill out in front. Vermette out of the corner. Antoine Vermette broken up by Mike Fisher, and again, all the way back, no icing here. Keith Yandel's back to play it. Run into on the forecheck. A steal by the Preds. Here's Marty Erat. Erat holding onto it. Good pass for Sergei Kostitsyn, but it jumped his stick. Now Erat in the corner, defended. Yandel was there, and now at the point, Bouillon. Give back as it's sent in by Sergei Kostitsyn. Derek Morris up the gut, back out to neutral ice.
I think Nashville's doing a better job on the forecheck here in the second period.
Shane Doan has room. His shot caught by Rene. 9:59 left to go in the second period. Joe Micheletti with Nashville coach Barry Trotz when we come back. We're back in Glendale. It's time now for Edward Jones FaceTime with Barry Trotz.
Barry, you talked before this game started about not having much history with this team. What are your thoughts now as you played a period and a half?
Well, you know, the first period, we looked rusty. You know, the 8 days, I knew it was going to be a little bit of a tough go for us there, but just because you get 8 days and getting back into the emotional state and all that. As we go forward here, we just got to limit our mistakes, just like on the wall right there, that second goal. You know, we just got to stay with our guy and not try to put it through his path. So just managing a puck against a very good team that's good on transition, we got to do that a little bit better.
Appreciate your time. Thanks.
Well, thank you.
And it might be just little mistakes on both sides when you look at this series and how it plays out. Korpakoski off a stick. Coming down now, rattle off for Nashville, and out they come. The 3-on-2, Kevin Kline for Mike Fisher going wide. All the way across in the skates of Gabriel Bork. Now Phoenix will jump on it. Taylor Pyatt out to center. Moving up on Roman Josi. He'll delay his shot, hung on to by Pekka Rinne.
There's the glove of Pekka Rinne. Again, one of the best gloves of any goaltender in the world. And when you see him making a lot of saves with that glove, he tries to stop everything using the glove. Here it is again, the quick wrist shot. There it is, reaches out, controls it well. When he's controlling that puck and it's not popping out of his glove, you know he's sharp. And we saw the odd man rush, one of the few, John, in this game, the 3-on-2.
9:25 left in the second period. Off the draw, Shea Weber. Winds it along. Game two of this series will be Sunday night here in Glendale. Patrick Hornquist out of the corner. Centers one. It goes off Andre Kostitsyn. And all over him was Keith Yandel. Kyle Chipchura will gain center ice. Rim it by Rene. Off the stick of Hal Gill. Brulé goes deep. Chipchura along the wall. Wedged by Hal Gill. Francis Bouillon in control. And out come the Nashville Predators. Bouillon now will clear it off the stick of Mike Smith. Now a turnover. Gill back to the point. Bouillon, his shot goes wide through a screen. Hornquist denied. Mike Smith, it's loose and poked in off the scramble. It kicked out. Andre Kostitsyn was on the spot. And Nashville has tied it.
Now, John, this has been a period where the aggressiveness of Nashville has been more apparent in the offensive zone. Their defense have gotten much more involved, and this was a play where Hal Gill, known for his defense, but you'll see him pinch in. He comes way in top of the circle. There he is. Keeps the play alive. Now they get a shot. It gets deflected. Bodies start heading to the net, and it just as Mike Smith was going to put his glove over the puck, you'll see a stick come in and just poke it right there. All three forwards for Nashville right on top of the goaltender Mike Smith. But it all starts with a good play by Hal Gill to keep the play alive by being aggressive in the offensive zone.
Andre Kostitsyn, who they acquired from the Montreal Canadiens at the trading deadline, gets the goal off that goal mouth scramble. Great save by Smith on Patrick Hornquist. But Kostitsyn, who's a goal scorer, found a way to get it done. We're deadlocked at two. Now Martin Hanzel through the middle. Knocked out of midair and dumped in by Michael Roosevelt. Good look at Shea Weber. Radim Verbata on the forecheck. Now Ryan Suter will peel back in his own zone. They start again. Cleared along the boards out to neutral ice. Wessel is there for Phoenix. He'll dump it in, but it's whistled dead offside.
Now Barry Trotz talked about getting their legs. And again, they just have a little bit more jump to their game here in the second period. And speaking of these periods, that's where Dave Tippett, the Phoenix coach, says that's where momentum changes take place most often, is in the second period and in overtime, because both teams have to make the longer change. So if you can sustain pressure in the offensive zone and tire a team out, that's when you have your best chance either to draw a penalty or to score a goal.
Andre Kostitsyn, his second goal of the postseason, 13th lifetime. Patrick Hornquist, Francis Bouillon get the assist. The goal comes at 11:19. Brandon Yip with a goal tonight. Walks in on the Phoenix defense. He'll get it deep. Paul Gostad for Craig Smith, defended by Antoine Vermette. A pinch by Kevin Klein off of Yip. Keith Yandel, good job here setting up Shane Doan, and out they go. Doan now with Bucker at his side, goes deep. Mikhail Bucker with a finishing hit on Kevin Klein. Craig Smith wedged out of the zone again by Gostad. Phoenix attempts to get to it as it's sent back out to center, whistle dead. And now a skirmish. Shane Doan in the middle of it all.
Now Roosevelt, I believe, got slashed on this play right after the whistle, or right when the whistle was going. There it is. He gets a slash right on the hands just as the whistle was going. He takes a slap back with his stick. Shane Doan steps in to help out on the play.
Just a little reminder for Brandon Yip after that hack on Michael Roosevelt.
Now, we've seen throughout these playoff series, some of these series, when they start, we see the teams go right after one another. Some of them, it takes a little bit of time.
Right.
And when you have, I think, two teams that, again, they don't have a lot of history, so there's not that natural rivalry. Sometimes it takes just a little bit to get these teams going, and I believe it's starting to get going.
And that would make the coaches happy. That's what they wanted. They wanted that to build, and they wanted it early. They didn't want to waste any time with that intangible. It comes all the way back. Damon Lenko given a shove by Francis Bouillon. Out of that corner scrum, it's gained by Hal Gill. Out to center, Hornquist has some room. Patrick Hornquist with a shot deflecting wide of Smith. Good block by Keith Yandel. Now Kyle Chipchura for Phoenix. Gilbert Brulé. Moving up on Hal Gill, Chipchura turns. Brulé denied by Rene. Loose out in front. To the point, Roosevelt. Chipchura. Yandel has some room. He goes wide. Keith Yandel wide of Rene. Chipchura checked by Gill. And in Lanko, Kyle Chipchura again. A wrister blocked in front by Patrick Hornquist, who gets it out.
And another good shift by the fourth line of Phoenix. Good offensive zone pressure that led to a couple of chances by their defense.
Francis Bouillon in control. A 2-2 deadlock here in game one. Roosevelt in his own zone, paired with Oliver Ekman-Larsson. To neutral ice, Taylor Pyatt. Boyd Gordon hits a seam. Good play by Hal Gill. He's been a force in his first game. McCoyne with a shot, loose out in front, and a good stick as they get to it, helping out that time Marty Erat.
That would have been a wide open net for Taylor Pyatt, and you're right, Erat came across and made a real strong defensive play.
Taylor Pyatt moved along the wall, broken up. Phoenix stays on it. Pyatt with a shot, it ricochets high. Boyd Gordon centers one off the paddle of Rene and dumped out. They relieve pressure. This will be icing with McCoyne getting there first.
And now let's see, as this crowd really gets into it, you can just feel the intensity of this game starting to build. The players going at one another a little bit more. And let's see if there's not going to be a timeout. And Dave Tippett is saying, let's go, let's drop the puck. And so Phoenix, of course, can make the change. There's the last opportunities.
I believe Barry Trotz now, yeah. Joe, will take his timeout, both burned.
I think it's a right timeout. Again, it was very similar to the pressure earlier in this period when Nashville had the pressure on Phoenix for an extended period of time in the offensive zone.
Get live NBC national games right on your Verizon 4G LTE smartphone with Verizon 4G LTE NHL Game Center Premium. Call Star NHL to download today only from Verizon.
John, you made a good point about Hal Gill, who we just saw there on the screen. He has played a very strong game in his first game back. He got hit with a shot back on April 5th by Sheldon Surrey, who's got one of the hardest shots in the National Hockey League. He plays for Dallas. And it's taken a while for Hal Gill to get back in the lineup, but he's been important in this game.
Well, he was so excited this morning, he pronounced himself in the lineup. The coaches always play that very tight in terms of who's in, who's out, but Hal was chomping at the bit to get back in, and he's played so well. Another iced puck, another faceoff in the Nashville zone.
So Nashville has to keep their same group of players out there. And did you see Hal Gill's new mohawk? He's joining the ranks of some of the younger players that are starting to go with the mohawk look. And he is now in the group. It looks great.
On him. Joe, exactly. You stay away from that. Now Hal Gill out to center. Here's Marty Erat over the line, moving up. Fisher for the front. Erat delays. Nice pass, Sergei Kostitsa, but a good defensive read by Martin Hanzel, and out they go. Hanzel gets to it. Over the Nashville line, he'll send it in. Whitney on the wall, detected by Fisher, who was very good in round one as it comes back out. Phoenix down with control. Oliver Ekman-Larsson, he'll get it deep. Pekkarinen fans on it. A steal. Whitney getting it from Verbata. But the pass and escapes. Now Hanzel given a shove at the defense by Shea Weber. Whitney holding on to it. Ray Whitney back to the point. Ekman-Larsson off a body. Off Radulov, played by Gabriel Bork. The second chance. David Legwand back out.
Bork went to clear it. The puck bounced over his stick.
Nadim Verbata, Antoine Vermette. Moving it by the Nashville defense. Here he comes. He has Whitney out in front. Oh, Rene! Beautiful stop.
What a pass. And Whitney could not have let go of that shot any quicker than he did. What a save.
Radulov walks in. His shot goes wide of Smith. Alexander Radulov turning away from the defense. Good play by Mikael Bakker, but better work by Radulov. Legwand will keep it deep. Shane Doan looks over his shoulder. Moving up on him, Kevin Kline. Now Kleslaw off the boards, takes a hit from Legwand. A loose puck. Outnumbered chance. Bakker with Doan. Two on one. Bakker holds, delays. He scores! What a goal! Mikael Bakker!
Pressure by Nashville, and then Kostitsyn, you see him, the forward, he moves up, and Bodker waited and waited and waited. How about that patience? The play by the defense was to take away the pass. Klein did that, and Mikael Bodker waits and waits. The pass wasn't there, the great release, and what a playoff Mikael Bodker is having for Phoenix.
I guess so. Two overtime winners in round one. His third goal of the playoffs. A former first round pick, 22 years of age. Mikael Bakker, Antoine Vermette, who's red hot. Rusty Klesla, 2 points tonight. Gets the other assist. Boyd Gordon, defended by Patrick Hornquist, Gorpakovsky. Taylor Pyatt taken off the puck, loose to the corner. He's given a shove by Bouillon, who did it twice. Gordon detected. Andre Kostitsyn moved out to center. Nick Spaulding is after it for Nashville. Now through the center zone and back.
And John, the way these two teams play defensively, it's a surprise to see a two-on-one odd man rush. It just doesn't happen very often.
Now Pyatt again goes wide of Bouillon. Button hooks. Looks around. Lays it back. Damon Lanko. Rene races out to play it. At the defense, Hal Gill in back of Pekkarinen. Pass comes all the way across for Nick Spaulding. Turning back is Oliver Ekman-Larsson. Off the boards, Michael Roosevelt. It's a change. Nashville almost got caught. Now back out to center ice.
Now Kelly Sutherland, the referee, was there and looking and waved it off.
2:11 left to go in the second period. Mikkel Bakker is having a great playoff run. You're watching the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico.
Now we talked about how aggressive the Nashville defense have been in this period. There's Josi, right side of your screen. He pinches in, but instead, Vermette makes the play 2-on-1 the other way. And now Bakker with that time and that room, and he just simply outweighs Klein. And what a shot to make it 3-2. This place is buzzing.
It is. As they appear in the second round. Phoenix Coyotes, this organization, the first time they've been able to do that in this market. They moved here from Winnipeg. Started play here in 1996. It comes all the way back in. Moved up top. Shea Weber off the stick of Mikkel Bakker. To the center zone. Detecting that one was Weber. Fisher run into by Klessler. Now it's played by Sergei Kostitsyn. Moving down to Suter out in front. What a save! Mike Smith a dandy.
Well, Suter joined the rush, the defenseman for Nashville. He'll join the rush from the other side. You'll see him come into play right here with the puck. And then the pass, the redirection. What a glove save. Suter with a perfect pass. And there's the redirection by Marty Erat. And Mike Smith with a beautiful glove save to keep this a one-goal Phoenix lead.
1:36 left in the second period. Here in game one, out to center ice. Taylor Pyatt gets it in. Back to play it is Shea Weber. Long stretch pass is detected, but not brought in the zone by Gabriel Bork. Rattle off, had it poked away by Michael Roosevelt. Phoenix will survive as they dump it out. Shea Weber to Gabriel Bork. Ekman-Larsson up the boards, a steal. Rattle off out in front, chip wide by Bork. Now David Legwan. Hacked a bit, up top by Gordon. Ryan Suter looking for a tip. Rattleoff's after it, Bork. Oh, Smith got a pad to it. Gabriel Bork out in front. Smith got a piece again as he was set up by David Legwand.
What a save. Couple of turnovers by Phoenix in their own zone led to that chance.
Now Shea Weber coming back. Paired on defense with Ryan Suter. 35 seconds left in the second period. It's dumped in, it deflects in the screen, and we get a stoppage. Great goaltending again by Mike Smith.
This second period has been about offensive chances for both teams. Here's the chance by Bork, who's had a big series for a rookie, or a big playoff, I should say. It comes to him. He's looking for his fourth goal of the playoffs, and Smith stretches over. Long, lean, 6'4", gets over. Very athletic goaltender is Mike Smith. And he's just able to get enough of that so it deflects over the net.
And a great story in terms of perseverance. Mike Smith, a late bloomer. Always had a lot of hope. At one time played for Dave Tippett in Dallas. Has come into his own. It trickles in on Smith. He'll freeze and get another faceoff. Let's take a look now at our forward update. Andre Kostitsyn with his second goal of the playoffs. Mikkel Bakker has been dynamite for the Coyotes. Third goal and the difference maker here in this one, and the faceoffs controlled by the Coyotes.
Now you get back to Mikkel Bakker, and he was a player that stepped in last series against Chicago when they really needed him, because Korpikoski got hurt, missed some games, and they put Bakker in his spot, and they did not miss a beat. And of course, as you mentioned, John, a couple of overtime winners as well.
And even a guy like Kyle Chipchura came through in game six with a solid game and a goal in that one, taking the spot of the suspended Rafi Torres. Now it's loose. Moving in, Andre Kostitsyn, Nick Spaulding off a stick. Vermette in a battle, a penalty upcoming against Phoenix. That'll be assessed at the horn. And a disturbance after that horn.
We're starting to see this second period has brought us more of the shoot short fuses that we see with players playing in the playoffs. In the corner, you see Vermette. He takes down Kostitsyn. And then a couple of pushes. Kostitsyn comes up, retaliates. And I believe the only penalty, we'll wait to hear, but I believe Vermette is going to put Phoenix shorthanded to start period number three.
Stay tuned for the Discover Card second intermission with Liam McHugh, Mike Milbury, and Keith Jones. The Coyotes have an unsung warrior. We'll tell you about that. And they'll tee up the Kings and Blues showdown in the Western Conference. That comes your way after the break. 40 minutes in the books here in the desert. And the Phoenix Coyotes in game one have a 3-2 lead over the Nashville Predators. The Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico. The Stanley Cup playoffs on NBC are brought to you by Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. And by Verizon 4G LTE, America's fastest, most reliable 4G network. Beautiful night in Glendale, Arizona. Game number one of this best of seven. The Phoenix Coyotes with a 3-2 lead as we get set for period number three. Let's take a look at the Lexus competitive edge.
Well, how about we talk faceoffs? And it's been an area where Phoenix has dominated in this game. You look at both Martin Hanzel and Antoine Vermette. They've been terrific through two periods.
Antoine Vermette in the box for Phoenix for holding at the 20-minute mark. Nashville gets a chance to tie it with a power play. Mike Smith's at the bench. A little attention for the skate blade. He's okay as we see the Nashville Predators, who have had a week to think about this after eliminating Detroit at home on Friday night. Admittedly, by their coach, a little bit rusty at the outset, but were better in the second period, but also took some chances that went against them. Yep. Phoenix Coyotes, to their credit, Joe, where they belong.
Yeah, and worth mentioning again, Shea Weber is their big gun on the point on this power play for Nashville, but Phoenix has held him to without a shot through two periods.
John Forslund along with Joe Micheletti here at Jobbing.com Arena. Ryan Suter. This is Shea Weber at the point. The slap pass off the stick of Mike Fisher. Fisher now broken up, and it's dumped out of the zone by Boyd Gordon.
And even on that play, Weber gets the puck. He looks up. There's no place to shoot. This penalty-killing team of Phoenix does a heck of a job blocking shots and getting in the lane.
Game two will be Sunday night here in Glendale. Ryan Suter giving a shove. Dug out by Fisher all the way back. Corralled by Shea Weber. Indirect pass. Finding Fisher. Mike Fisher now sets up shot. Pulls it back to the boards. Inside it goes. Blocked by Hornquist. Great save by Smith. Artie Erat. Ryan Suter up top. Erat again. Off a body. Suter. This way for Weber. Inside Mike Fisher. With a pass that deflects back to Ryan Suter. He's hurried by Damon Lanko. Fisher give off. Shot taken by Erat tonight by Smith. Run into by Hornquist. And play is blown dead.
And Mike Smith upset after he made the save. Pretty good puck movement by Nashville. Here's the puck movement. They get Phoenix to back off. And Hornquist, one chance, two chances, even a third. As Smith took away everything down low. Look at Smith. No place to go with that puck down low. Great job of goaltending.
Barry Trotz told us this morning that he stays right along that goal line. Sean Burke, the goaltending coach here, has got him to be a little bit deeper in his approach. You saw it there, 18 stops tonight.
He just doesn't have as many holes in his game as he used to for a big athletic goaltender. And Sean Burke deserves an awful lot of credit. Remember, Sean Burke also had Ilya Bryzgalov here in Phoenix. And he had some wonderful years here before moving on to Philadelphia.
Off a faceoff, it comes back. Sergei Kostitsyn walks it deep. It ricochets through the goal mouth, and now it's played again by Nashville. Roman Josi getting it back from Radulov. Alexander Radulov delays. Moves wide, his pass off a stick off Ekman Larson. Played by Sergei Kostitsyn. It's punched ahead, batted down with a high stick. and it stays in play.
John, the Phoenix players here didn't like the way the linesman dropped the puck. They thought it was an unfair advantage. It was a clear win for Nashville. That gave them that control, and that led to a scoring chance before now Phoenix able to clear the zone.
Nashville has three shots with this power play. 4 seconds left in it. David Legwand. Shot taken by Josi, denied by Mike Smith. Loose in back of the goal. Hansel moving by Radulov. Hansel tries to move it in a tough position to be in, and now it's dug out by Radulov. Alexander Radulov creates room for himself. Lays it back for David Legwand. Off a stick, it goes high. Michael Roosevelt. Now Roman Josi. Good work by Radulov. Throw on the brakes. Look out in front. Center one off the stick. Smith twice, three times. Comes up big. Booyah had the last chance.
Beautiful pass from Radulov from behind the net. And the defenseman for Nashville continue to get aggressive and move into the play. Here's Radulov. Patience, patience, patience. That one goes off the side of the net. One shot. And then the second one by the defenseman. 51 is the defenseman, Booyah, who moved in on the play. And how about the quick glove? Beautiful save by Mike Smith.
In tight. So many of those tonight. Brandon Yip broken up. Keith Yandel for Phoenix. Out they come. We'll angle it off. Brandon Yip. Played here by Pekka Rinne. Score check by Ray Whitney. And Rinne took down Whitney.
And gets a penalty for it. Well, let's see. Maybe they're going to even this out. Let's see. I thought initially there was going to be one. It might be evened up. It might be diving. Let's see what Ray Whitney does. Now Ray Whitney goes down, so they're going to give Rinne or Pekka Rinne a penalty, and then Ray Whitney, I believe they're giving one also. Let's see.
Interference on the goaltender, Pekka Rinne.
Oh, my mistake. Pardon me. Just the one.
2:47 is the time. Third power play for Phoenix. They are 1-for-2. Hal Gill. Radim Vrbata with a power play goal. Well, it's broken up here by Paul Gostan. He'll float it out. Set the Phoenix power play. Mike Smith will leave it for Keith Yandel. He'll man 1 point. Oliver Ekman Larson on the other side. Radim Vrbata. Martin Hansel. Ray Whitney up front. This is Vrbata. Loved down by Hal Gill and right back out. Gary Trotz, the Nashville coach, now changing up the penalty-killing unit. Sergei Kostitsyn, Mike Fisher up front. Kevin Kline and Hal Gill are back. Vrbata, they gain entry with Hansel. Now Ekman Larson for Keith Yandel all the way across off Fisher. Played by Kevin Kline. And he'll kill some time as he gets it all the way down to Mike Smith with 68 seconds left in this power play. Keith Yandel has 5 assists. That leads all defensemen in playoff scoring. Yandel now through the middle. Knocked down by Marty Erat and again back.
Not many places for Phoenix to go. I mean, they're just trying to get back. Everything's being broken up in the neutral zone by Nashville. This is outstanding penalty killing.
Excellent off-ice pressure. Now Legwand back for Shea Weber. All kinds of time. He'll salt it away as he dumps it in with 35 seconds left in the power play. Oliver Ekman Larson starts from his own zone. Crowd a little bit impatient with this, but Nashville deserves the credit. Now it's Butker. Mikael Butker, a sweep check by Paul Gostad. It goes by Pekka Rinne. Shane Doan gives chase for Phoenix. Broken up. Dumped ahead by Spaulding, but not out. On the wall, Shane Doan goes to work on Ryan Suter, who defends it well. It's punched ahead off the glass. Shea Weber clears it off the boards and all the way down to Mike Smith.
There's so much pressure being applied by Nashville that for Phoenix, they need a little bit more movement and more support on the puck.
Brandon Yip, who is serving the penalty for the goaltender, is out. Even terms on the ice where it counts. Phoenix by 1 in game 1. Sergei Kostitsyn giving it by Marty Erat. Keith Yandel in control. Turning with it is Damon Lenko. A retreat in his own zone. They'll start again. Yandel Young defenseman from Boston. Laid off here for Derek Morris. Through the middle, over the line, Lanko. With a shot blocked by Kevin Klein, who gets to it. Forecheck by Lanko. Now Mike Fisher alertly along the boards, coming down to it. Sergei Kostitsyn. Roman Josi. Now Kevin Klein has all kinds of time to wheel it out. Through the middle of the ice, it deflects past the Phoenix goaltender, Mike Smith.
Important penalty killer for Nashville. Pardon me, John. They did with trailing by a goal here in the third. They got the job done on the penalty kill.
Now Hensel. Whitney moves up, defended by Francis Bouillon. Whitney gets room for himself. Broken up by Gabriel Bork. Not out. The play read by Whitney. And now coming back to it is Alexander Radulov, who's checked by Martin Hensel. Francis Bouillon off the boards and out. Michael Roosevelt hinges for Phoenix. Dropping it back for Verbata, we get a stoppage. 13:44 left in regulation time from Glendale. You're watching the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico on a beautiful night. Here in the desert, Glendale, Arizona, John Forslund, Joe Micheletti back with you. Inside Jobbing.com Arena, the home team up by one, attempting to win a second round playoff game for the first time in their organizational history. It comes all the way back. Derek Morris forechecked a bit, getting to it and dumping it out of play.
That's a penalty.
And a penalty on Radim Verbata.
Radim Verbata is going to go to the penalty box. He fires the puck over the glass. And there is no argument. 17 is Verbata. Gets a loose puck, feels a little pressure, forced to get rid of the puck, and over the glass, shorthanded is Phoenix.
Nashville to the power play for the fourth time tonight. As it troubles Dave Tippett, who was a great penalty killer as an NHLer, his team and his teams always have been. Phoenix is on quite a run here in the postseason. It was stellar against Chicago, shorthanded, and so far it's continued tonight. At a critical stage with 13:19 left in this third period, the team with the puck is down by one. Marty Erat moves in. Fisher and Hornquist out in front. Patrick Hornquist with a shot, great save by Smith. Fisher's after it, it's knocked down. Derek Morris, Boyd Gordon, out she goes.
And John, that pass was actually meant for Shea Weber on the other side.
Ryan Suter coming back. They'll lead it out to center ice. He'll wipe it deep. Smith had it, lost it. Ekman Larson. Forecheck by Erat. It pops out. Phoenix, good positioning. Lanko away for Shane Doan, sealed off by Ryan Suter. Damon Lanko. For the captain, Shane Doan, it goes deep. Shea Weber moves it. At the top of your screen, it's Mike Fisher. They reorganize. 57 seconds left in this power play. Through the middle of the ice. Andrei Kostitsyn, Alexander Radulov across. David Legwand. Hurried a bit by Gordon. Cleared out again. Oliver Ekman Larson.
His stick is so good. His defensive positioning. They start talking about Ekman Larson. And they mention Nick Lidstrom a little bit.
They do.
How's that for company?
It goes by Roman Josi.
Now this is a lot of one-on-one play by Nashville. They get it over the blue line, and right away Phoenix closes in. You can't beat them one-on-one.
Alexander Radulov moves it. A sweet check there. Josi in control. He'll go deep. 11 seconds left on the kill. Phoenix gets it all the way down to Pecorine. Roman Josi, only 3 seconds left in the power play. The rookie now gains center. He dumps it in. Verbata's out of the box. Four in a row killed off by Phoenix. Now back of the goal, they circle. Turning with it is Brandon Yip, who has a goal tonight. Getting away from Roosevelt. Brandon Yip, good job here, stopping and starting. Antoine Vermette turned it over. Yip again turns his shot. Fought off by Smith. Craig Smith for Nashville up top. Bouillon with a shot, it goes high through a screen. Now they play it deep. Out of that corner. Paul Gostad to the point. Francis Bouillon. Gostad turns. Good play by Vermette on him. Phoenix gets it out. Rene is out to play it. Francis Bouillon goes across. Chipped ahead in the nick of time by Kevin Klein. Sergei Kostitsyn, Paul Gostad. A bouncing puck. And Emelianenko back to play it for Phoenix. 10.5 left in this third period. Back out to neutral ice. Wedged along by Shane Doan and captured again by Shea Weber. Weber through the middle. Off a stick. Fisher, indirect pass, Erat. His shot sails high over the top of Smith. And back out for Doan. Shane Doan racing across beautifully. Ryan Suter. Doan stays with it. Shane Doan centers one. It goes off the stick of Chipchura. Gained again by Doan. His chance is blocked. Kyle Chipchura turns for the Coyotes. Keeps it deep. He goes down. Play continues. Now Gabriel Bork.
Momentum change now. All started with the penalty killing for Phoenix.
David Legwan inside. Broken up by Keith Yandle. Chipchura hands it off. Radim Verbata going wide of Pekka. Played off for Yossi, and there to play it is Whitney. Ekman Larson for Phoenix. Knocked down by Radulov. Gained by Hanzel. In deep for Whitney. Roman Yossi is on him. Whitney does a good job down low. Hal Gill now for Nashville. Back out. Radulov's away. Alexander Radulov turns. Holds onto it. Lays it off for David Legwan. Back to the point. Unattainable for Hal Gill. And a good break for Phoenix.
Legwan looked to the net. No place to go. He looked back to the point. No place to go.
Interception by Lauri Korpikoski. And Hornquist now is back to play it for Nashville. Patrick Hornquist will clear it wide of Mike Smith. Phoenix is without a shot on goal in this period. Nick Spaulding plays it ahead. It deflects in the screen. We get a stoppage. 8:47 left in regulation time. His team down by one.
Let's take a look at our, from our LensCrafter RoboCam. This is the penalty killing of Phoenix. And what a job they do. Sticks in the passing lanes, blocking shots as we've seen throughout this game. That was a big opportunity for Nashville to tie the game. But the penalty killing of Phoenix held them to just one shot.
You see what Phoenix has done in terms of faceoffs tonight too. So in all these intangibles, they put themselves in a position to get a jump in this series and protect their home ice. Nashville crosses the line offside. We get a stoppage. Let's go inside the glass with Joe Micheletti.
Well, the other thing is that for Nashville, they had their big defenseman Hal Gill back in the lineup tonight after not playing in the first round. And he's been a very effective player. He's killed penalties. When he does that, his big body, he blocks shots. He gets over and uses a long reach to defend. He's played physical when the time has come. And how about pinching in and getting involved in the offense? This led to a goal, and all started from Hal Gill getting involved in the offensive side of things. He's also a plus two in the plus minus side, so he returns to the Nashville lineup in fine form.
We expect a close series, and that's what we have received here in game one in terms of how the game has been played. Verbata now will carry out. Dean Verbata with a first goal in this series. Scored on a power play early in the first period. It goes deep. Francis Bouillon back to play it. Game two is here on Sunday night. To the center zone, Kevin Klein moving it by the winger. Now Craig Smith, that winger, will keep it deep. Keith Yandle interrupts the play. Martin Hanzel springs Ray Whitney. Radim Verbata. Whitney the trailer, give and go time. Out in front. What a stop by Rene as he robs Martin Hanzel.
Odd man rush. It starts in the Phoenix zone. A quick pass up the boards. And they come back three on two. All three forwards for Phoenix caught up the ice. You can see in the background. And then the beautiful passing. Verbata with the final pass to Hanzel, who just kept on going to the net. There's the beautiful passing between Verbata and Ray Whitney. And Hanzel just tries to deflect that perfect pass in. And beautiful save by Pekka Rinne.
Joe, that was their first shot in this period.
You know, John, this is a team that throughout even the first round of play, I think when they go through periods where they don't get many shots, it doesn't bother them. They're very comfortable playing this way.
The long stretching. Butker is wide of Rinne. Klesla for the goal tonight. It's centered. Vermet with a chance. It goes wide. It was set up by Shane Doan. Mikhail Butker on a cycle for Antoine Vermet. Shane Doan protects the puck, shields it. He's knocked down as he was defended by Ryan Suter. Sergei Kostitsyn moves up, lays it off for Fisher all the way across. Good read. Bodker got in the way, and Doan has control.
What a play. That defensive play by Suter led to a 4-on-3 for Nashville, and Bodker made the defensive play.
Boyd Gordon taken care of by Roman Josi. Hal Gill, his first game of the Stanley Cup playoffs, injured throughout the Detroit series. David Legault out in front. It pinballs in on Smith. No further play. Sunday, the IZOD IndyCar Series continues on the NBC Sports Network. Open wheel racing hits the streets of Brazil for the Sao Paulo Indy 300. Coverage begins at 10:30 a.m. with IndyCar 36 featuring Ryan Hunter Ray on the NBC Sports Network. .646 left in regulation time. Nick Spaulding and Boyd Gordon, who's been an excellent addition, signed as a free agent last summer, and he is a great faceoff man.
Not just that, but he has been an excellent penalty killer for them. He's played the third and fourth lines, so we can put him in an offensive role at times as well. His all-around play has been excellent.
Roman Josi, the panel down, and it's controlled by Mike Smith. A little bit of a slow whistle. Another faceoff, you know, in the Phoenix
Smith,
zone.
I'm not sure he knew exactly where that was. He did put the stick down, but the puck seemed to, they seemed to lose sight of the puck, and I'm not sure he exactly knew where it was. It'll be the backhand shot. He goes down, it goes through the stick and disappears someplace on the other side of the stick. So it goes underneath the stick, and it might have just hit his left skate and stayed out, but they're going to take a look at this.
Yeah, they are, Joe. The officials and Kelly Sutherland, along with Chris Lee, are the referees tonight. We'll take another look from the net cam.
Here we go. It goes through, and let's see. You could see the puck rolling towards the goal line, but then it was, the view was obscured. There it's in, but had the whistle already gone? I think it did by that point, by the time we saw it there. So I think they're going to take a long look at this in Toronto at as many angles as they can. Let's see if we can hear the whistle go. Yeah, it was definitely after the whistle when the puck went in the net. The question is, did it cross the goal line as we lost sight of it? Hard to tell from that angle.
Well, Kelly Sutherland now, who made the call, confers with the situation room in Toronto. 6:24 left, as we see.
And remember, to overturn what was a no goal on the ice,
right,
there has to be conclusive evidence.
And it was tough.
Yeah, from those
angles. See that completely. And
right,
the whole puck has to be over the goal line.
Right. From those angles, it was inconclusive. But again, they'll take a look at every view they have. They'll take their time up in Toronto to try and make sure they get it right. And Kelly Sutherland now is off the headset, and here's the answer.
The play on the ice, the puck is saved by the goaltender, does not go in on the original shot. The play is called dead, therefore call on the ice stands, no goal.
Seemed like the right call, didn't it, John?
Absolutely.
From everything we saw, and then when we listened to the whistle, the puck eventually went into the net, but that was clearly after the whistle had blown, and there was no evidence from what we saw that it was in the net prior to the whistle blowing.
Yeah, and the only other thing we'll say is it's the act of blowing the whistle too.
Correct.
So that's the key in the interpretation of the official who's doing that and taking it and blowing the play dead. 6:22 left.
And another faceoff win. Boyd Gordon again. They just can't win a faceoff and get it back to either Weber or Suter for a shot.
Nashville is trapped offside. We get a stoppage here. Shots are 26 for the Predators, 18 by Phoenix.
And that faceoff win by Boyd Gordon was clean. I mean, straight back. And now you've got Phoenix that has the puck. And Nashville trying to win a faceoff to get the puck back to Weber or Suter, either one, but they can't win a faceoff to do so.
Boyd Gordon won't get this chance. He's won 10 out of 15 draws so far. And Nashville now in possession. Shea Weber will scale it ahead. Roosevelt coming back, looking over his shoulder. He has some room. He's sealed off by Legwand. Hand on by Weber. In the center zone, Ryan Suter taps it ahead. Good hustle by the Coyotes' Boyd Gordon. It's gloved down by Suter through the middle. Broken up by Whitney. Here he comes. Ray Whitney to the outside of Shea Weber. Inside now, they go deep with it. It's centered. Attempted pass that time by Ekman Larson up on the play. Here's Martin Hansel. Hansel turns. Laid back for Oliver Ekman Larson. Roosevelt walks it down on Radulov. He'll stop, given a shove by Radulov, and it's played here by David Legwand. Two on two with Gabriel Bork. At the line, Bork goes after it. Hansel is there for Phoenix. He'll attempt to win that battle from the rookie Bork. It pops out. Erat. Francis Bouillon with a shot. Stopped by Smith. 5:11 left to go in this third period. We go down the stretch in game one. The Stanley Cup playoffs on NBC are brought to you by the redesigned 8-passenger Honda Pilot, the SUV made better. And by GEICO, proud sponsor of the NHL. Night number one of the second round here in Phoenix. Shea Weber and the Nashville Predators trying to come back from one goal down.
He doesn't have a shot on goal yet in this game. They're trying to keep him on the ice as much as possible, but Phoenix doing a good job against him.
Mike Smith, a save on Mike Fisher, and a penalty. The jam out in front, it goes against Phoenix.
Holding the stick in front. That was a shot that seemed to get through a number of players, and Smith picked it up late and kicked out the left leg. Shot from well out, but it leads to a penalty. Might have been deflected on the way. And then in front is Boyd Gordon, one of their top penalty killers, and he ends up in a penalty box. That's exactly why coaches tell their players, let's just keep getting shots to the net. It was an innocent looking shot, but it led to a penalty, and now a power play and a chance for Nashville to tie this game.
Power play number 5 for the Nashville Predators. Off the draw. Patrick Hornquist gets control. Suter moves it across for Shea Weber. It goes by Marty Erat. Patrick Hornquist now around the wall for Mike Fisher. Back to the point. Played here by Ryan Suter. Fisher again holding onto it. Ryan Suter with a shot stopped by Smith. The rebound. They score. Marty Erat's on the spot. And Nashville has tied it.
Well, they've been moving the two defensemen, Suter and Weber, to different sides. This time, Weber ends up on the right side. Suter is able to take the shot with all the traffic in front. In front is Hornquist. There's Suter. Look, he's looking at that straight through. Four people forces Smith to make a save, but it's a tough save and a tough puck to control. And then all the traffic in front. And Erat is left alone and has a chance to bury it on the backhand and ties it. Tough puck to control, then some contact in front. Smith couldn't reach the puck. And it all stems from that shot on goal that led to a penalty and then the power play chance to tie it for Nashville.
For the long time, Nashville Predator, Marty Erat, comes up with a power play goal. Phoenix had killed off 18 in a row. Now they cross in the person of Mikhail Botker cutting. Doan with a shot. It ricochets wide of Rene. Heath Yandel. Shane Doan. Defended by Roman Josi. Patrick Hornquist will attempt to get it by Keith Yandel. Phoenix now will jump on it in the center zone.
John, it's almost as if Phoenix, if they don't give up a late goal in the game, they don't feel comfortable. All those late goals that they gave up in the Chicago series, but they came back to win that one in 6.
They were so good when maintaining a lead in the regular season going into the third period. In the postseason, it's been a different story. Roosevelt sealed off by David Legwand. The assists go to Patrick Hornquist and Ryan Suter. Erat, his first of this playoff year and his 8th lifetime at 15-18, and again on the power play. Out of that scrum, Ekman Larson moved out. Held in by Weber. Kicked out with a purpose by Smith. To the corner it goes. Hansel in control. And here they come. Radim Verbata. Over the line. Good play at the line by Shea Weber. They transition. Alexander Radulov cutting. He has some room. It goes off Ekman Larson, who plays it. Oliver Ekman Larson now will stretch it out.
David Legwand coming back also made a good defensive play that led the rush the other way.
Radulov goes after it. Mike Fisher at the line is denied, and Alexander Radulov moves it back.
Nashville has had the puck most of this period.
Phoenix with only one shot on goal in this period. They circle, a chance. It deflects in on Smith, who says no. The play initiated by Marty Erath.
Well, as Barry Trotz was telling us this morning, one of the leaders on his team is Marty Erath. So he scores the goal to tie it and then has this chance. Just throws it in front, deflects off a skate. Smith has to be alert. He has that pad right along the ice to prevent it from going in.
2:51 left in regulation time. Boyd Gordon and Marty Erath. This time Erath is given the boot, but Mike Fisher, an extra center, will come in and take this draw, won by Gordon. Kleslo. Back out to center ice. Francis Bouillon paired on defense with Hal Gill. Fisher, Erath, Sergei Kostitsyn for Nashville. Boyd Gordon, along with Lauri Korpikoski and Pyatt are out there for Phoenix. As we get another faceoff in the Phoenix zone, the Coyotes have been giving up late goals, and they've been doing it in the postseason.
It's tough to come back from that, because generally what happens is you see a momentum swing for the team that scores the late goal to tie it. And yet Phoenix, with all their resolve, when you talk to their players and their coach and Dave Tippett, everything they've been through, they are a very callous team as far as things that have happened to them both on and off the ice.
Ryan Suter with a shot, deflects off a stick off Derek Morris. Now it's carried out, a move deep by Kyle Chipchura. He'll go after it. Defending him is Shea Weber. Weber gets away from the checking from Shane Doan. Weber's in the zone, tries to move up on Yandel. Knocked down by Yandel, now played by Andre Kostitsyn out in front. Just out of the reach of David Legwand, all the way down to Pekka-Rinne. Under 2 minutes left in regulation time. Pekka-Rinne stick handling with that puck.
That's a good job by Bodker to put pressure on him.
Here's Radulov again. That great speed, his shot goes wide of Smith. Played this way by Martin Hansel, spinning off a hit, thrown at him by Gabriel Bork. Bork hacks at one, tries to keep it deep. Roosevelt moves it back. Here's Oliver Ekman-Larsson. With about 90 seconds left in regulation time. Roosevelt back again for Ekman-Larsson. Nashville awaiting Phoenix in the center zone, so Ekman-Larsson will dump it in. Rinne in the trapezoid. Plays it over the head of Verbata, chipped by Gabriel Bork. Through the middle of the ice, off the stick of Marty Erath. His goal is tied it. Now Roosevelt for Phoenix. 65 seconds left in regulation time.
I think Erath's been the best player on the ice here in the third period.
No doubt about that. It comes all the way back for Ryan Suter. We'll play it up. Snapped by a coin, and here come the Preds. Patrick Hornquist throws on the brakes. His shot blocked by Kleslo. Gained by Nashville. Fisher, Ryan Suter. Mike Fisher from the boards. All the way across, backdoor Weber, held in front off Smith. Gained here and carried out by Korpikoski. 35 seconds left. Lauri Korpikoski with a shot blocked by Ryan Suter. Hornquist back the other way, sealed off by Korpikoski, and again it comes back. 23 seconds left. Derek Morris will scale it deep. Slowed down by Pekka-Rinne. Played by Kevin Kline, read by Derek Morris off the stick of Rinne. 10 seconds left. David Legwand fed in by Antoine Vermette. 4 seconds left in regulation time, and as we saw so often in the first round, the second round will start with overtime. Little disturbance. Marty Erath with a huge goal on the power play late in this third period. Stay tuned for the Subway Overtime Intermission with Liam McHugh, Mike Milbury, and Keith Jones. Scoring by committee. And the Capitals' defense will be in action tomorrow in Game 1 of that series. That all comes your way next. The Subway Overtime Intermission Report. 60 minutes have been completed in the desert. A great game to start this series, which should be a close one. The Phoenix Coyotes 3 and the Nashville Predators 3 Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico. You're watching the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico. Game one, round number two out in the West. 3-4, Phoenix and Nashville deadlocked at 3 as we go to overtime.
And why not start that guy? Right? He's been hot for you. Mikhail Bodker with a couple of overtime winners in the playoffs this year. He is coming of age at 22. And Marty Erat, who was the best player on the ice in the third period, scored the big overtime, or pardon me, the big power play goal to tie it.
John Forslund with Joe Micheletti, who is inside the glass. 49 playoff games have been played so far, and 17 have gone to overtime. Some have been quick, and others have taken multiple overtimes. We'll see what this one gives us. This should be a great series. Shane Doan plays it right to the goal mouth, and it comes all the way back out to center ice. Marty Erat lays it off for Mike Fisher, but the Predators are offside as they cross. Let's see those overtime goals scored by Mikhail Bodker.
Now, sometimes it doesn't always take a perfect shot. How about this one? Almost at the goal line. Slides in past Corey Crawford. That wins it. Here's another one against Crawford. Didn't get that much on the shot. This one he scored tonight was a beautiful goal. Patience, and then that great release. Post and in. That made it 3-2 at the time for Phoenix.
Nashville tied the game on a goal by Marty Erat on the power play late in the third period. A period in which they outshot Phoenix 16-1. Ray Whitney broken up along the boards. Shea Weber tries to get it out. A second chance for Erat. And now Ryan Suter moves it all the way down to Mike Smith. Lay it off for Rusty Klesler with a goal tonight. Ray Whitney elevates the puck. It spindles ahead. Punched out by Roman Josi. Adrian O'Coyne moving it by Ray Whitney. It goes by Kevin Klein. He's back to play it. Along the wall, Martin Hanzel. Had an overtime winning goal in round one against Chicago. Now it's played ahead by Radim Verbata. And back out to center. Little chip by Hanzel. And it comes all the way down to Pecorine. Good look at Kevin Klein. Gabriel Bork. A quick up. Alexander Radulov. With a stutter step on Ekman Larson. He'll circle. Radulov wheels it off a stick. David Legwand takes over. He'll center off a body. Roman Josi with a shot. It deflects off Boyd Gordon. And it goes out of play.
Now Marty Erat, who scored the tying goal in the third period, was all over the ice. He was in quickly on the forecheck. He was going to the net. That was a deflection where Mike Smith made a very good save. Here's another one, a wraparound that goes off the skate, and then the power play goal to tie it. Goes hard to the net, finds the loose puck, and on the backhand deposits the puck in behind Mike Smith. And that's why we are in overtime.
Off that faceoff, Andre Kostitsyn and Patrick Hornquist for Nashville. Defended by Keith Yandle, a wrap chance to the goal mouth. And now it's played by Francis Bouillon. Off a body, Andre Kostitsyn with a shot, it goes wide. Little traffic out in front from Nick Spaulding, who drops it off for Patrick Hornquist. Francis Bouillon centers one, negated by Derek Morris out in front. Now Spaulding, defended by the Coyotes' Keith Yandle. It kicks out. Morris in control. Phoenix will attempt to get it from their own zone. Taking a hit to get it deep was Boyd Gordon, but this is icing with Francis Bouillon back on the touch.
Yeah, and Phoenix is going to have to find a way to get their offensive game back. You mentioned the shots in the third period, John. Totally in favor of Nashville. And the play. I mean, they had the puck. Nashville had the puck in the third period. And here now, Phoenix, they're having difficult times getting out of their own zone.
Brandon Yip with a shot stopped by Mike Smith. Off that faceoff win. Yip again. Smith twice. Greg Smith had the second chance. Gostad off the paddle of Mike Smith. Brandon Yip with a chance blocked. It's loose. Fought for in the crease and covered by Mike Smith. With some chaos out in front.
Well, Brandon Yip is involved with Lauri Korpikoski. I mean, when that puck was on the ice, everyone just converged to a certain area. I'm not sure if anyone saw exactly where the puck was laying, but right off the faceoff, Nashville wins this one. They haven't won many. That turns into that shot off the side of the net, and then they just keep going to the net, And that puck is like a magnet. It just draws everyone in. Both teams pushing, shoving, trying to find the loose puck. Eventually, I believe Mike Smith did.
And Paul Gostad, who they went out and got from Buffalo for this reason, will take another faceoff.
And Phoenix, with the last change, gets a fresh line on the ice. Their fourth line. Lanco will take the faceoff against Gostad.
Gostad goes right-handed, as he often does. Now Ryan Suter broken up by Chip Chura. Shea Weber, a quick up, unattainable, broken up. Phoenix transitions. Cleared in by Gilbert Brulé. Pecorine wristed himself, knocked down, played, and carried out by the Predators. We're looking at Brandon Yip. Ryan Suter goes wide. They'll try and move it by a coin off the side of the goal. Craig Smith in control. He'll center one, broken up by Damon Lanco. And out they go. Lanco through the middle. On the wing, Brulé. His shot ricochets high off a stick. It was deflected by Ryan Suter. Craig Smith out of the University of Wisconsin. His shot blockered down by Mike Smith. Now played along the wall. Mike Fisher pinned a bit by Lanco. Chip Chura. Lanco will go off on a change right now as he gets it deep.
And now as we get to overtime, remember, both teams have the long change. So it's imperative for both to try and stay on the ice for short shifts and not cut off for some of those extended shifts that we saw in the second period.
Mikhail Bakker, forechecked by David Leguan. It pops out. Oliver Ekman-Larsson in control. Moves off of the wing for Shane Doan. Broken up by Kevin Kline, dead center. Picked up by Derek Morris. He'll get it deep. Alexander Radulov for Kevin Kline. Escaping pressure. David Leguan through the middle, glove down by Gabriel Bourque. Radulov goes wide. Moving on Roosevelt. He'll circle. Alexander Radulov out in front. It kicks back for Roman Josi. His shot tipped wide. Now Roosevelt, Radulov, David Leguan for Nashville. Roman Josi, Alexander Radulov cutting. Moving on Roosevelt. Putting on a show. The backhander goes wide. Now they circle again. Gabriel Bourque out in front. Just by David Leguan. Shane Doan. As Phoenix will survive that sequence and get it deep.
Nashville's confidence with the puck has just continued to grow from the third period. Start of the third period. And again in this overtime. They have had the puck most of the time.
And Joe, they get it deep again. Hornquist takes a hit. Andre Kostitsyn out in front looking for Nick Spaulding. Hornquist has Spaulding. He's hit by Martin Hanzel. Bouillon off a body. Hanzel. Out they come. Radim Vrbata over the line, pulls up. Martin Hanzel goes to work. He'll circle. Whitney's out in front. Hanzel off a body off Al Gill. Gill in control. Moved out to neutral ice. Roosevelt calmly away for Hanzel. And now Bouillon back in his own territory. 5.5 gone in overtime. Over the line, Spaulding. He goes off on a change and deep again it goes. Roosevelt plays it along the boards. A chip back out to center. Ryan Suter peppered by Pyatt as it comes back out.
Good recovery by Suter. Pyatt with a good forecheck. Suter looked like he was in trouble and was able to recover.
Shea Weber sends it all the way back. This will be icing. Michael Roosevelt on the touch.
And let's not forget the importance of faceoffs. Again, there was a late, Roosevelt went down as he went back to touch the puck. And so that brought everyone in. As Nashville was trying to negate the play. And Roosevelt slowed down a little bit. Thought he had plenty of time. I don't think it was the stick. I think he went down on his own. I don't think it was the contact. It didn't look like the stick made contact with the skates. And there you see the shots and the importance again of faceoffs, which throughout this game, even though a big shot disadvantage lately, they've been winning faceoffs.
Keith Yandel. Broken up by Paul Gostad. Off a stick, off Brandon Yip, and out to play it ahead of that goal line is Mike Smith. Derek Morris through the middle, broken up by Gostad. Played again by Yip. Brandon Yip off a glass support. It's offside. We get a stoppage. Actually, it went out of play. It hit the curved glass just inside the dasher board, so we get the halt in play.
Yeah, so the faceoff will come at the center line, as it was Nashville that was trying to clear the puck in the zone when it went out of play. Again, continued short shifts for both these teams.
Ryan Suter and his team have confidence now, really, in terms of their team game for the first time in game one.
I thought the game changed for Nashville when their defense started getting more involved.
Right.
They started pinching in, they started joining the rush. They did give up a goal, the goal by Bodker, because they got caught playing that aggressive style. But it changed the way the game has been played.
Marty Erat now turns away. Broken up. Wessla in control. Detected by Erat. Laid off for Fisher. The pass up top broken up by Bodker, and out they come. Two on two. Mikhail Bodker moving it by Ryan Suter. He goes to work. Rene's out to play it. Off of Bodker. Mikhail Bodker sets up a man. It's punch. Great save. Rene off the stick of Hanzel. Nashville gets it out. Radulov moves up, lays it back. Suter with a shot at the flex wide. Ryan Suter off a body off Mike Smith after it deflected. Off the shin guard of Mike Fisher. Ray Whitney. Broken up. Radulov back the other way with Legwan. Alexander Radulov. Roman Josi with a shot wide. Martin Hanzel for Phoenix. A quick up. It's Whitney. Radim Berbata. His shot. Punched down by Rene.
Quick shot. Great release by Berbata. Right through the defenseman. And that's a quality save by Rene.
Roosevelt forechecked by Gabriel Bork. Radim Berbata in the center zone. Broken up by David Legwan. He's defended. He takes out Boyd Gordon. Taylor Pyatt goes after it now. Patrick Hornquist. Kevin Klein. Indirect pass, Andre Kostitsyn. Michael Roosevelt there for Phoenix. The Predators now again get it deep. Boyd Gordon looks at Patrick Hornquist, who's forechecking. Roosevelt went down. Andre Kostitsyn holding onto it. Hal Gill out of his reach and all the way back.
Now there again, you see though, Hal Gill was pinched in way to the top of the circles looking for a chance.
Hal Gill through center ice. Handing on a pass, Craig Smith. Nick Spaulding to an open corner. Adrian Aucoin. Oliver Ekman-Larsson, the 20-year-old, through the middle. Phoenix escapes harm. They get it out. Now Gill is back to play it. Just about 9 minutes gone in overtime. Pawed down, cleared in by Brandon Yip. Paul Gostad handles the chores, and now Mike Smith will leave it there. The coin away for Ekman-Larsson. A long pass, unattainable for Gilbert Brulé. Ryan Suter is back, and icing is called.
Well, there haven't been many scoring opportunities for Phoenix, but Bodker gets one because he makes a defensive play. Watch him in perfect position. There he is, steals the puck. Now he's got the great speed, goes down the other way, puts the pressure on Pekka Rinne to give up the puck, and then that led to a chance. And then one other one, Radim Vrbata with that tremendous release of the shot, forces Rinne to make a good save.
Mike Fisher and Damon Lenko on the draw, won by Fisher. Suter, one-timer, Weber, what a save! Mike Smith, and he handles the rebound.
And then Fisher gets involved. Fisher won the faceoff by using his skate to kick the puck back. And that was the first time in this game where we've seen Weber able to get a shot from the point. Watch, he'll kick the puck there. And now Weber, what a shot. And Smith with the quick glove had to keep it. Here's the kick. And then Suter, the setup to Weber. First time in this game we've seen the cannon from Weber, and Smith had to be alert.
39 shots. The latest from the guy with arguably one of the hardest shots in the National Hockey League, right behind Zdeno Chara, Shea Weber.
Yeah, the play happened so quickly that Phoenix could not get out into defensive position in time to get in the shooting lane to attempt to block that shot.
Antoine Vermette take an important faceoff for the Coyotes.
And now they're moving both Suter and Weber having a conversation where they want to get stationed. You see Suter, he's directly behind the centerman, Erab.
Off the draw, Ryan Suter has it. His shot ricochets high. Shea Weber in control. Down deep, out of the reach of Mike Fisher. Ryan Suter again. Marty Erab in back of Mike Smith looks it over. Erab for Fisher, fanned on. It's loose. Plesla's after it. So is Shane Doan. They move it out. Adrian Acoin back in his own zone. Veteran defenseman for Rusty Plesla. Headmanning for Mikkel Bakker. Here's Antoine Vermette with a shot caught by Rene. No further play.
And he knows most of the shots that Phoenix is getting are from well out. They're not able to sustain any offensive zone pressure, or very, very little, where they get in and get a forecheck going and turn the puck over and put some pressure and force Nashville to defend. Nashville, for the most part, has been looking up ice. And they've been able to keep the pressure in the Phoenix zone.
Hansel, Whitney, and Verbata come out for Dave Tippett. Kostad will take the faceoff for Barry Trotz, and off the draw. Here's Verbata. Looking for Whitney, denied by Roman Josi. Leguan chips it ahead. Radulov with good speed, moves up. Cuts, has room. Alexander Radulov goes to work. He'll throw on the brakes. Here's Kevin Kline, his shot off the body. A good block by Michael Roosevelt. Phoenix will get it out. Martin Hansel, Radim Verbata. Hansel for the front. His shot is blocked by Josi, and it goes out of play.
Now Josi, another one of those young players on this Nashville team. He came over and made a real good defensive play on Verbata. Verbata looking to just try and get a shot on goal. And Josi, one of the young defensemen from Switzerland, was able to get a stick on that shot. Radulov has become more dangerous as this game has gone on. Third period and in overtime. Two-time most valuable player in the Continental Hockey League, where he left Nashville and spent four seasons over there. Two-time MVP, scoring leader, all-time scoring leader in that league.
Well, Joe, let's see how we have been able to get to this point as we take a look a long way back at the first goal by Verbata.
That was a power play goal. And then this one, the bounce off the glass, the tap in for Yip tied the game. And then later on, Rusty Klesla gets a fortuitous bounce. That made it 2-1. And Nashville then started to get their forecheck going. That made it 2-2. They did give up an odd man rush here. And Mikkel Bakker made it 3-2. But a third period power play goal by Marty Erab here tied it and sent this game to overtime.
That was on their fifth power play. Radim Verbata and the Phoenix Coyotes had killed off 18 in a row dating back to the Chicago series. Six of their first seven games decided in overtime, the first time that's happened in NHL history.
Well, just standing next to them on the bench here, they look comfortable.
They should be.
Nothing seems to bother them. They found ways to get things done. And they just go about their business. Again, as we talked about earlier, John, this has been a team that, you know, in many games they've given up long stretches where they haven't had many shots, have been outshot badly, and they just kind of go about their business and try and get the job done, which they've done.
It's a great matchup. Game two will be Sunday night right here, off the draw. A loose puck, Hornquist has it, out they come. Nick Spaulding, defended by Derek Morris. Hornquist, flushed out a bit by Keith Yandel, now getting to it is Morris. The veteran will reverse it for Keith Yandel. Moved out here by Ray Whitney over the line, getting room. Whitney inside, it goes Verbata. Shut down by Rene. Out of the corner, Whitney goes after it. Now it's played here by Patrick Hornquist.
Now, one thing we are seeing in this overtime are both these teams, when they get an opportunity to shoot, they're shooting from every angle.
Well, the stretch pass for Whitney is just a bit offside. We get a stoppage.
Now, Phoenix, their last chance. Start behind the net, and then the long pass. And Ray Whitney gets the blue line, now can make a pass. And look at this angle, not much for Verbata, and he just puts it off the pad and off the post. on the short side of Rene.
Well, he had that second chance. Rene making sure he's right up against that goalpost. 9:09 left in overtime. Off the draw, Bouillon. Sergei Kostitsyn with a shot off bodies. It's loose. Smith recovers. What a save as cruising in with Bouillon.
He did not see the first save. It hit him, but then found the puck to make the second one. And he's without a stick.
He'll set up again. Fisher. Hal Gill. Bouillon holding onto it. Smith still does not have a stick. Boyd Gordon. Forechecked by Mike Fisher. Bouillon again. Good stick by Pyatt. Now it's Gill. Hal Gill moves up. Centers one across. It ricochets off the glass, stays in play. Sergei Kostitsyn turning as Mike Fisher, defended by Boyd Gordon. Adrian Acoin moves it along the boards, not out. Bouillon, Gill hammers one. It deflects wide. Fisher again. Gordon in control.
Somebody should have given this, their stick to Mike Smith, the goaltender. And now Smith skates to the corner to get it. There's the whistle, and this is an icing.
And Sergei Kostitsyn was shaken up.
Meanwhile, just prior to that, boy, what a couple of saves. The first one, it didn't look like he saw it, but then finds this one and kicks out the right pad. Gorgeous save by Mike Smith. The rebound, the athleticism, 6'4", hits him, and what a save. Wow. That is brilliant.
Absolutely incredible, Mike Smith. What a season, what a playoff so far. Taylor Pyatt pinching in with Shea Weber.
No, they need a change. They're going to try and change now. This might be a bad change. Nashville might catch them here.
Good call, Joe. They almost did. Weber now moves it back. Ryan Suter, Gabriel Bork. Coin, Smith out to play it. He'll do it himself. Shane Doan, Antoine Vermette. And now Bodker tries to sneak in. Rene out to play it. Shea Weber has time. A quick up. Radulov peppered by Ekman-Larsson. Here's Roosevelt ahead of Gabriel Bork. He'll turn. Play it off for Mikkel Bodker. Head manning again for Michael Roosevelt. Moving up. He can't get it by Weber. Reorganizing. Phoenix through the middle of steel. Paul Gostad steps in. Tries to walk through the D. Swept aside by Smith. Brandon Yip. Turns along the boards as Craig Smith out in front, along with Gostad. Yip off the paddle of Mike Smith. Gained again by Bodker. He'll wheel from his own zone. Shane Doan. Coyote captain Antoine Vermette. No problem for Pekka Rinne.
Now, if you're Nashville now, you've got to be wondering, what do we have to do to score? They've spent most of this overtime in the Phoenix zone. Phoenix only getting long-range shots.
Craig Smith turns it in deep. Reading the play was Derek Morris. Long pass intended for Kyle Chipchura. Yossi's back icing again.
Well, we saw Kostitsyn go down to the ice. You'll see this play in the corner. He just gets in the way of that attempted clearing shot. Catches it, goes up high. Kostitsyn gets it in the face. Down to the ice he goes. He remained down for a while. Another key faceoff.
Phoenix gets possession. Lenko winning it from Mike Fisher. Sergei Kostitsyn. Here they come. Fisher to the outside. His shot stopped and hung on to by Mike Smith. And now Sergei Kostitsyn jams away out in front.
Well, the Phoenix defensemen are doing everything they can to try and keep the Nashville forwards away from their goaltender. Because Nashville has done a marvelous job at just getting to the front. Here's a turnover. Puck stays in the zone. Again, Nashville became more aggressive in the second period, and there's a quick wrist shot by Fisher and Smith. Another good save. All the quality chances in this overtime and in the third period have been by Nashville. It just makes you wonder what would happen if Phoenix could get one.
Well, they had the game at the 15-18 mark of the third period when Marty Erat scored. And now a game that has been dominated by Nashville, and the only reason it's still here is number 41. 42 shots on Mike Smith. Ray Whitney. Vadim Verbata. In the glove hand of Pekka Rinne. Laid along the boards. Sergei Kostitsyn. Through center, all the way back. Icing will be called here, and we'll swing it back in the Nashville zone.
One of the few offensive zone faceoffs that we've seen in overtime for Phoenix. And Hanzel, who's been one of their best, will attempt to win the draw. His wingers are very active off these faceoffs.
They get their top line out. Hanzel, Whitney, and Verbata. Here's a chance. They score! Ray Whitney is the hero. Phoenix gets it done once again in overtime.
This is a set play off the faceoff. Hanzel goes to his backhand. Watch Whitney, middle of your screen, goes right to the far post. And Hanzel wins it, throws it there, and Whitney puts it in. It wasn't easy, a bang, bang play. Whitney up his skate first, and then the reach. What a goal. Phoenix again finds a way. There's the play, set play. We talked about active wingers. Whitney was active.
His second goal of the playoffs. Watch the celebration. Their goaltender keeps them in a position. And as Joe Micheletti said, a great play off a faceoff. Martin Hanzel will get the only assist. The 21st playoff goal scored by Ray Whitney, who's standing by with Joe Micheletti.
Nothing to it, huh, Ray?
Well, there was more to it than we needed. I mean, again, Mike Smith was the key tonight. If you look at the shots again, we were even with them through two periods. They're pretty close, and when we try to hang on, we're just not as successful as we want to be, and he gave us a chance again tonight.
You didn't have many offensive zone faceoffs in that overtime or in the third period, for that matter. Set play there on the game winner?
Not really. I just kind of saw what Marty, the way his body was positioned. I held for a second, and when I saw him go through, I figured I'll just go hard to the net. And a little bit fortunate on the bounce, but certainly we will take that for sure.
Does your team ever panic no matter what the situation is? It doesn't seem like it.
Well, depends. I mean, when we're up a goal, it seems like we're a little bit tighter than we should be, but we hang in there. We're obviously very comfortable in overtime, seeing as we go to a lot of them. So, you know, I think when you've got a goaltender like Mike Smith in net, it gives you a little bit of a calming effect.
Congratulations.
Thanks, Joe. I appreciate
it. Thank you. John?
Thank you, Joe. Stay tuned for the Bud Light postgame show with Liam McHugh, Mike Milbury, and Keith Jones. We'll take a look at the Saturday doubleheader. Then they will take a look at an historic overtime run. Great hockey in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Phoenix takes a one-game lead in this best-of-seven series. They win for the first time as an organization in the second round. They defeat Nashville 4-3. For Joe Micheletti and our whole crew here in Phoenix, this is John Forslund. Thank you for joining us tonight. 4-3, the Coyotes in Game 1. So long.